And a very good evening from London Stadium. This is BBC Radio 5 Live Sports Extra. We've got full Premier League commentary of West Ham United against Bournemouth coming up right here from the London Stadium. It's a 7:30 kickoff. That is 5 minutes' time. The bubble machine is in full flow, pumping bubbles into the air. They've got a light show in motion. Big night for West Ham with their January signing. Coming in to make his debut, Calvin Phillips, who has joined on loan from Manchester City. And with the return of the likes of Edson Álvarez and Mohamed Kudus, who has scored in his last four appearances here at this stadium, there is an expectant mood from West Ham supporters. But Bournemouth have shown in recent months that they can compete with the best of them. And they've been very pleased to hold on to Dominic Solanke through this January transfer window. His goals have been so important to Bournemouth. Only Erling Haaland and Mo Salah have got more in the Premier League so far this season. For West Ham, they are sixth in the table. This is a game in hand on all the teams above them, apart from Manchester City. And a win here for Moyes' team would see them move to within 5 points of Tottenham and Aston Villa in fourth and fifth place, respectively. For Bournemouth, will they start this evening in 13th? They've played two games fewer than most of the teams around them. A win here this evening would see Bournemouth move above Fulham and to within a point of Wolves in 11th place. I'm very much looking forward to watching this game alongside Matt Jarvis. Matt, big night for Calvin Phillips. We know the talent he's had with Leeds United in the past, with England, of course, where he's played so well. But it just didn't happen for him at Manchester City, and he will feel a pressure now to get this career back on track at West Ham.
Absolutely. I think he's, you know, what a great player he is. I think that's what he just wants to get back to, is playing week in, week out. And obviously he's probably learned a huge amount of tactical awareness and everything from, you know, training with Pep Guardiola. But he just wants to get back to playing games and to go into this West Ham team who are doing really well. You know, that just breeds confidence. And, you know, for the West Ham players, having someone fresh come into the team does wonders as well. They, you know, they want to go and impress Phillips, but he wants to come in and show everyone what he's about going into the summer.
So the debut for Calvin Phillips is the main headline of team news. He's one of four changes for the West Ham side that drew 2-2 with Sheffield United 11 days ago. Ben Johnson comes in and plays it right back because Vladimir Soufal is suspended. He was shown a red card at Bramall Lane. Mohamed Kudus comes back from his African Cup of Nations duties. Edson Álvarez back in the team as well. Maxwell Cornet and Danny Ings, who both played well at Sheffield United, may well be a little disappointed to be dropped to the bench. And Pablo Fornals, who has been linked with a deadline day move back to Spain, is not in the matchday squad this evening. The Bournemouth manager, Antonio Areola, has made four changes from his team's last game. That was their 5-0 win over Swansea City in the FA Cup last week. Neto returns in place of Mark Travers in goal. Adam Smith is back at right back ahead of James Hill. And Marcus Tavernier and Antoine Semenyo are either side on the wings. They come in for David Brooks, who's left the club on loan, and also Luis Sinisterra, who is on the bench. So Areola, the goalkeeper for West Ham, back for Johnson, Zuma, Mavropanos and Emerson. Three in the midfield, Suchek, Phillips and Álvarez. And then James Ward-Prowse getting forward in support of Kudus. And Jared Bowen up top, who is West Ham's top scorer this season and who scored against Bournemouth the last time these sides met. We know that Bowen can score the goals. They're still lacking maybe that obvious number nine, but he does a job, doesn't he, Jared Bowen?
He does. He does it really well. You know, he's got that pace and his finishing is really, really proven. You know, if he gives him that chance, he's scoring goals. But they are wanting that centre-forward play because, you know, Bowen wants to favour that right-hand side. He always drifts out there. He cuts inside onto that favoured left foot, but he's been outstanding up there at the moment.
So the teams are out on the pitch. West Ham wearing their traditional claret and blue. The Bournemouth team, who are wearing a change strip, almost a very pale light blue. Neto's their goalkeeper. Back for Adam Smith, Ilya Zabani, the Ukrainian, Marcus Senesi, the Argentinian, and Lloyd Kelly at left back. In midfield, Lewis Cook, who turns 27 on Friday, makes his 300th appearance for Bournemouth. He's alongside Ryan Christie. Then you've got Antoine Semenyo and Marcus Tavernier in the wide positions. Alex Scott will push forward, and Dominic Solanke leads the line. He scored against West Ham the last time these sides met in August. So a win this evening could get Bournemouth up on the coattails of Wolves in 11th, which is some turnaround from the opening months of the campaign, Matt, when Bournemouth seemed lost at sea in the Premier League.
Yeah, definitely. You know, you really would be looking back and thinking, wow, what a change to the team. But it took a bit of it took time for the manager to get his views and the ways tactically away, but they really are a great team now. You can see them working together, and they've got some fantastic results on the road especially.
The match is underway. West Ham playing from left to right as we look down. Challenging for the ball, Calvin Phillips, who's been given the number 11 shirt at West Ham. Free kick awarded just before the ball came to him anyway, and that's going to be a free kick for Bournemouth, and Lewis Cook to take it some 10-15 yards inside his own half. West Ham's next two games are high profile ones. They play Manchester United and then Arsenal over the next two Sundays, but this is an important game tonight at home in front of their own supporters and a chance to keep up the pressure in their hunt for a European place for next season. West Ham, who've really enjoyed their travails in Europe in recent times. Mohamed Kudus involved for the first time, runs down a bit of a blind alley, possession given away, and now Zuma's got to sprint back under pressure from Semenyo, and Kurt Zuma gets there first and puts the ball out of play for a Bournemouth throw. 0-0.
Yeah, I think that's where Bournemouth are going to look to attack you. Then one ball in behind with a good run from Solanke, or the two of the wide players running in behind, because that's where it's the only position really where Zuma can get found out a little bit. He's great in the air, he's good positioning, but if you can get a bit of grass in behind and you can run in behind him, that's the only point of a counter attack for Bournemouth.
West Ham 15 points better off than they were at this stage last season. A year ago, West Ham were just one place above the relegation zone right now. David Moyes, who tends not to tinker, he has trusted the process, and no club has used fewer players in the top flight this season. He's particularly pleased to have Mohamed Kudus back. No Saïd Benrahma this evening. He's suspended. He wouldn't have been involved anyway. He's been linked with the move to Lyon. We believe he's in France at the moment, but that deal is very much in jeopardy of not going through. Luis Paqueta hasn't played in three games in a row now because of his calf injury. Still no Mikel Antonio, who hasn't played since the November international break. West Ham have possession. Emerson Palmieri, far side of the pitch from us, rolls it infield to Kurt Zuma. And then a comforting touch for Calvin Phillips as he gets used to his new surroundings here at London Stadium.
Yeah, you definitely want to get that early touch. Yeah, feel of the ball, get comfortable, keep possession, keep moving it. And then, then you can work from that. You want to have a nice, easy start.
Here he is. He's under pressure. Oh, a mistake by Calvin Phillips. It was a poor pass to him from Kurt Zuma. But relief for West Ham because Bournemouth had the ball in the back of the net. Solanke's goal is denied. Wow. What about that? Calvin Phillips on his debut on what might only have been his second touch of the ball. He was tackled inside his own penalty area. Bournemouth got into the back of the net. Phillips thought he'd dropped a clanger. However, Adam Nunn, the assistant on the far side, raising his flag to say that Bournemouth were offside. Relief.
Oh, yeah.
Huge relief for Calvin Phillips.
Huge relief. We were just saying about getting a nice early first touch, and the ball's been played into by Zuma, and he just hesitates to pass the ball back. He gets a good touch, but so soft, straight to Solanke, who slots it away really comfortably. But luckily for West Ham and Calvin Phillips, it's the linesman had his flag up.
We're just VAR obviously looking at it. The reason I think there's a little delay here is the question, was it a back pass from Dominic Solanke, from Calvin Phillips? And that is why VAR looking at this maybe a little bit longer than seemed necessary initially. There's no doubt Solanke's in an offside position, but if the pass is a back pass from Phillips, which it is, and therefore the goal stands. Solanke played onside because it was a back pass, and the Bournemouth supporters celebrate a dream start for them. 3 minutes in, Bournemouth lead at London Stadium, and what a horror show for Calvin Phillips on his West Ham debut.
Oh, that is not what we were expecting to be saying tonight. Calvin Phillips' first few minutes is probably his second touch, and it's sloppy. Zuma's passed to him. He doesn't really want it there. Passed it inside the box, and he's under a lot of pressure, so he just tries to get his foot in, and it's just straight to Solanke, who's read it really well and puts it straight into the back of the net. But really disappointing start for West Ham, and especially Calvin Phillips.
So the goals keep flowing for Dominic Solanke. That is now 9 goals in his last 10 Premier League appearances, including tonight. He's up to 15 for the campaign. He was in the right place at the right time to take advantage of that situation.
That's exactly what he's been doing all season. You know, he's such a goal threat. and he's getting himself into the correct positions, and that must be the easiest goal he's going to score this season. It is straight to him, and he's got the open goal really pretty much to slot it in. But it's the pressure that Bournemouth are putting West Ham under. Even in that early spell, you can just see, as soon as it gets to Zouma, they're pressing him. As soon as it's going into Calvin Phillips, they're pressing, and they're high up the pitch.
What a remarkable turn of events for Calvin Phillips, and your heart does go out from a player whose clearly confidence was rocked a bit at Manchester City. Pep Guardiola decided quite early that move was not working out, and he used him as a very much periphery player. He's come to West Ham hoping for a fresh start, and he's made the sort of error that he never made in a City shirt and couldn't get in the team there. Free kick for Bournemouth, into the penalty area. It's going to be a chance, but the shot is over the top from Marcus Senesi. He had time and space in the penalty area after the free kick. He's rifled it over the top, and this is a big wake-up call to West Ham on a night that they were hoping was going to be a good performance from them. They are under pressure in these early stages.
They really are. The West Ham supporters are not happy at all. Need their team to wake up, but it was actually a really good opportunity. He's got to keep his head down to try and at least hit the target there, because he's had a free shot of goal from inside the box. Yes, it was on sort of like the half volley, but he's got to be able to try and hit that target.
So West Ham United 0, Bournemouth 1. Still very much early stages at London Stadium, but Androni Iraola has a spring in his step as he goes out to play ball boy there and to present the ball to Lloyd Kelly to take a throw in just in front of the technical area. Enormous technical areas at London Stadium, that large peripheral area around the playing surface. As Bournemouth have possession, Senesi plays it infield to Zabagni, and then from the halfway line he'll send it down the left wing, trying to get in around the back of Ben Johnson, who makes the interception and does well to keep the ball in play, but then he rattles it off Kudos, who can't control it, and the ball does go out for a Bournemouth throw, and they remain inside their opponent's half.
Yeah, West Ham need to take a breath. They need to get a foothold in this game already. They haven't touched the ball since the goal. Bournemouth have had all possession. They're passing it around like their usual style, getting it out from the back now as well, but West Ham need to take a touch, breathe. You know, yes, it's not been the ideal start. Calvin Phillips will want to get on the ball as quickly as possible to make up for it, really.
West Ham have had good powers of recovery this season. They've come back to win 10 points from losing positions in the Premier League this campaign. Two Bournemouth players collided with each other in the centre circle there, but Tavernier has been able to hold on to possession on the left-hand side, and then challenged by Kudos, he runs the ball out of play for a throw-in to West Ham, who trail here by a goal to nil. Ben Johnson, who came on to play in midfield in West Ham's last game at Bramall Lane against Sheffield United, did quite well in that central position, which he played for most of the, if not all of the second half. Senesi plays it forward here to Dominic Solanke, who tries to take on Mavropanos, last touch off the Greek international, and that's a throw into Bournemouth, who remain on the attack, and almost all of this game has been played inside West Ham United territory so far. Lewis Kelly has possession for Bournemouth. Back closer to the halfway line, Senesi. Into the centre circle, Zabagni. Turns under pressure from Bowen, gives it back to Senesi. And then Bournemouth work their way into the West Ham once again. Kudos, though, is very alert. He nips in to make the interception, and he's away down the right wing. He hits the deck. West Ham fans scream for a free kick. Nothing doing with the referee. Play on, Bournemouth regain possession.
Yeah, Kudos is a huge plus for West Ham. He was so effective, so instrumental in the way that they played before he's gone away. So they'll be desperate for him to come back and have that form that he had before he left.
Mohamed Kudos, who has missed the last four games in all competitions for West Ham, away at the Africa Cup of Nations with Ghana. They were eliminated in the group stage. That's why he's back tonight. He scored two goals against Egypt in one of those group stage games. Mohamed Kudos. We feel if West Ham are going to get back into this tonight, he could have a big effect on it. This is Edson Alvarez, the Mexican. Gives it short to Calvin Phillips, who's still hoping to settle in a little bit better now. West Ham just playing the ball around inside their own half. Zouma gives it back to the goalkeeper, Arriola. Alphonse Arriola, who went off late in stoppage time at the end of that draw at Bramall Lane last time out. He was injured while giving away a penalty, which only McBurney ultimately scored, but that injury has not kept him out of the starting 11 this evening, as the ball is shepherded out by Kurt Zouma for a goal kick to West Ham, away to our left-hand side. And a few groans, bit of disgruntlement from West Ham fans. This is not the start they wanted tonight, trailing 1-0.
No, it's not. And the thing is, these West Ham fans over the last couple of years have come to see their team, you know, do well, especially at the London Stadium. So disappointment. They want their team to start playing and start playing well.
Tavernier on the left for Bournemouth. Shows too much of it to Kudus. He cleverly there tried to backheel it off Tavernier. It didn't work, but it was a good idea from Kudus. Bournemouth have lost it in the midfield. Ryan Christie giving it away. This is James Ward-Prowse on the halfway line. West Ham playing from left to right as we look down in the claret and blue. Phillips onto Kudus on the right wing. Johnson's available on the overlap outside him. Right foot across, low in from Johnson. First time really West Ham have got it into the Bournemouth penalty area. And Bowen is well chaperoned. 3-4 defenders around him. Bournemouth clear it away for a West Ham throw. Matt Jarvis.
Yeah, that when they get it wide here, Ben Johnson is trying to whip that in low because there's only really Bowen that can get in there. Suchek's arriving late into the box, which he does so well, but there's so many Bournemouth defenders in there just on Bowen. They need to get numbers into the box.
This is Johnson, who's received the throw-in back to his feet, but challenged by Lloyd Kelly. The ball goes out for a throw-in. For a goal kick. Goal kick to Bournemouth, the way to our right-hand side. And for their goalkeeper, Adam Neto, who has had no drama so far in these opening 10 minutes. There's been plenty of drama in the game, but it's been down the other end. But Calvin Phillips, well, the spotlight will be on him because it's his debut tonight, because he's a high-profile player and he's come from the Champions, but I think the pass to him was doing him absolutely no favours as well.
No, I mean, you don't want to be receiving the ball there. It's the first sort of minute or two in the game, and you don't want to be receiving the ball with your back to goal inside the box, in your own box. It's not where David Moyes would want them to be playing, passing the ball around.
Do you see so many Premier League teams that was at Villa Park the other night, and it's incredible how they play it out from deep position. I mean, they don't mind giving it across their own goal, giving it to a player marked in their own penalty area. They will play, and that confidence and throw, I mean, in a way, it's asking for problems, but it's exhilarating to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. But that's the thing, them players are used to it. The manager demands it. I don't think David Moyes will be demanding them to be playing the ball inside the box.
Not to Calvin Phillips in the 3 minutes into his debut, no. Absolutely not. Solanke's taking advantage. Bournemouth are in front. This is Suchek for West Ham. Passing the ball out to Edson Alvarez, who comes deep into West Ham attacking area. And then Bowen's attempt to cross to the left comes off a defender. For the first time tonight, something for the West Ham fans to applaud. They have got a corner. 12 minutes played. West Ham 0, Bournemouth 1.
Yeah, but set pieces are huge for West Ham. When you've got Ward-Prowse that can deliver a ball onto a sixpence, he's a huge threat. And you've got Zouma, Mavropanos, you've got Suchek in there. It's a huge threat for West Ham.
Yeah, this is an area that Bournemouth tend to struggle. They concede a lot of goals from set pieces. Ball is played in towards the front post, and it comes off a West Ham player and out for a goal kick. So goal kick to Bournemouth, who lead here in the early stages. This is BBC Radio 5 Live Sports Extra at London Stadium tonight on what is a dry, chilly evening. Dark skies overhead, the playing surface here illuminated, and Dominic Solanke's goal separating the teams. West Ham, who are yet to win a game in any competition in 2024. Zabania has it deep at the back. Goal kick was taken short. He'll roll it back to Neto. Now to Senesi on the left-hand side, and his left-footed clearance up over the halfway line is one for Solanke to chase. He's beaten in the air by Mavropanos. And then Tavernier gets it back down on the deck for Bournemouth. Tries to set play in motion. Runs into the lively Kudus. Quick feed from him. Regaining possession for his team, and it's back with Zouma on the edge of the West Ham United penalty area. West Ham still to get properly warmed up in this one. It's an Alvarez out to Emerson Palmieri on the far side, and good pressure again from Semenyo, hounding in on top of James Ward-Prowse there and forcing West Ham back once again.
Yeah, I think you've got to give Bournemouth a lot of plaudits. You know, the way that they're pressing and they're really making West Ham work. Every time they get the ball, they're pressing high with pace, and I think that's the key thing with pace. I think any defender gets a bit, as soon as you've got a player with pace that's running in behind you or running towards you, you start just getting that little bit of fear, and you want to make sure your touch is right. And that's exactly what Kudus is doing here for West Ham.
Kudus has kept it in play on the far side. Great burst into the penalty area. Now Bowen brought to the byline. Right-hand side as West Ham come forward. He's got support of Johnson. It's still Jared Bowen. It's a poor pass towards Kudus. And groans from West Ham fans as their team give up cheap possession there. And a chance of a counter-attack. And this is Tavernier scorching his way into West Ham territory. Pulls it back for Semenyo. West Ham working hard to get players back behind the ball. It's been end-to-end for the last few minutes in this game at London Stadium. West Ham 0, Bournemouth 1. Shot from Cook from distance is spinning away off target. And that's a goal kick for Areola. West Ham 0, Bournemouth 1.
Yeah, good break from Bournemouth. It showed a lot of pace for Tavernier down this left-hand side, who plays it inside to Cook. And, you know, no player from West Ham comes out to close him down, so Cook decides to take the shot, and it wasn't too far away.
So West Ham conceding inside 4 minutes this evening. They scored themselves inside 4 minutes 3.5 weeks ago in the FA Cup against Bristol City. That was the game when West Ham had the early lead but were then pegged back 2-2 and forced through to a replay. This is Calvin Phillips, who, while we were discussing other things, made a good challenge on Semenyo a few minutes ago. That's probably the most positive contribution that he's made so far. Backheel from Suchek is well executed. And Johnson plays one out towards the left, but he's played a pass to a ghost because there's no one out there for West Ham.
No, the groans again from the home fans here. You know, they haven't got a hold of this game at all. Bowen's not been able to get into the game yet. Kudos is there. He's the player that they need to get on the ball. He makes something happen, and he's not been able to affect the game at all yet.
Throw into West Ham, trailing 1-0. This is Five Live Sports Extra from the BBC. You can listen to Wolves against Manchester United commentary over on our sister station, Five Live. That kicks off in half an hour from now, and it'll be half-time here at London Stadium. Emerson's gone down. West Ham want a free kick. Play on to the referee. Phillips shoots from the edge of the box. His first shot as a West Ham player is straight to the midriff of the Brazilian goalkeeper, Adam Neto.
I bet he wished that went in. Oh, it was good angle from him on that left-hand side, on his right foot, trying to curl it into that far corner, but just not enough on it, and it was an easy save for Neto.
Free kick to Bournemouth. Foul on Dominic Solanke inside the centre circle. West Ham finding it difficult to build momentum in the early stages of this game tonight.
I think it's an interesting one to look at how they're lining up as well, West Ham, because they're trying to have like Bowen up on his own with Kudos wide right, and they got Ward-Prowse out on the left, and Suchek's trying to occupy sort of like a off the striker, off Bowen in it. They haven't seemed to got this together at all, because now where Cook is on the ball, that's where Suchek should be, and there's a lot of space in the middle of the park there.
Yeah, Bournemouth have found it easy to carve through the West Ham midfield in the early stages. Here comes Tavernier, cutting in off the wing on the left-hand side, waits for some support to arrive. Lloyd Kelly makes himself available into the midfield again for Lewis Cook, and out wide to the right-hand side to Adam Smith, who's played more Premier League games in a Bournemouth shirt than anyone else. Sunesi has it, 10 yards inside West Ham territory. Bournemouth playing from right to left as we look down at London Stadium. Tavernier's picked out a lovely ball to Semenyo, and he's been able to turn and break into the penalty area, and his shot is deflected out for a corner. Could have gone anywhere. Dangerous attack from Bournemouth. Semenyo gets a corner for his team.
It's really good slick passing from Bournemouth. They go out to the left, out to the right, coming back, and it was Tavernier who made a clever pass first time straight into Semenyo, used his strength to shrug off Alvarez, who's got his left foot, but it just got blocked by Mambrapanos, I think it was, to deflect wide for a corner. But really good play from Bournemouth, good strength from Semenya, and to get his shot off.
Corner's going to be taken by Christie, wide on the left-hand side. He's rolled it short, gets it back again from Tavernier. Now the right-footed delivery, he's got a lovely swing in it. That was a great delivery. Header comfortably into the stomach of the goalkeeper, Areola, but a firmer touch there. I think it was Zabani who got the touch. It was more like it hit him and into the arms of the goalkeeper rather than he was able to apply any momentum to the cross.
Yeah, any sort of touch from him, and it's in the back of the net. He's literally inside the 6-yard box. Areola hasn't moved. It's actually come as Zuma's actually got the head. It's ricocheted off him, and I think it hit Solanke's arm as well on the way through to Areola. But it's a really good ball in there, dangerous ball inside the 6-yard box, but well dealt with in the end.
Yeah, good whip delivery, which West Ham were relieved to deal with. Zuma's attempting to clear it out, came back in off Zabani and just popped into the grateful arms of the goalkeeper, Areola. We've played 19 minutes, West Ham 0, Bournemouth 1. Five Live Sports Extra. Down goes Christie, push to the back from Thomas Suchek. Free kick to Bournemouth, just inside their own half.
Yeah, that's Suchek getting a bit frustrated. Yeah, you know, he's not been able to get on the ball at all in this opening, you know, opening half. He's trying to understand what his role in the team is, where he's supposed to be, and he's finding it difficult to get in the game.
So 1-0 to Bournemouth. Throw into the visitors near the halfway line. Lloyd Kelly looks for a darting run by Dominic Solanke and picks up the goal scorer. He's forced out into touch. He wants a free kick. Referee says no. Throw into West Ham. Right full back position. for them. Don't forget the Six Nations starts tomorrow. You can listen to Five Live commentary of France against Ireland. It's the opener of the competition from Marseille, built up from 7 o'clock kickoff at 8 o'clock tomorrow night on our sister station Five Live. Here come West Ham. Bowen really busting a cut to try and get in between the two defenders. He's managed to win a corner for his team there in between Sinisi and Sabah. Oh, it's not going to be a corner. Bowen runs back towards the referee to complain, goal kick Bournemouth.
And as you can hear, West Ham fans are not pleased with that. But I think on the replay, it is correct decision. They slid back into Zavagna, is slid into Bowen, and he's flicked it off Bowen's foot to go out for a goal kick.
More live sport on Saturday on Five Live. Our pick of the 3 o'clock games is Newcastle against Luton from St James's Park, and then later on at 5:30 on Saturday, Sheffield United host Aston Villa. You can listen to that game here on Five Live. There'll be Six Nations commentary of Italy against England. It's a 2:15 kickoff, and also Wales against Scotland, which begins at 4:45, and that's available on Sports Extra. Zabani clears the ball away for Bournemouth. Stretching for it is Alex Scott, and he is fouled by Calvin Phillips. Hits the deck. Free kick to Bournemouth inside the West Ham half. 20 minutes in, Bournemouth have been enjoying this. You can tell by their body language. They are relaxed demeanour away from home at London Stadium tonight, and they're winning the 50-50 battles of the moment.
They're very fluid. That's the thing with Bournemouth. They're very fluid. The way they pass the ball out from back, but it's dynamic through the middle. If they have that first time pass, it breaks the lines, and they've got the pace and power up the front three to hurt any team.
Free kick is taken by Cook, played in towards the penalty area. Johnson back defending on the right hand side, tries to hold it up. Lloyd Kelly tries to spin away from him. Does well to hold on to possession just about. And then it's back with Marcus Tavernier, who's played a low ball into the penalty area. Sinisi had stayed up there from the set piece. Alex Scott tries the left foot across on the left hand side, and that deflects out for another corner to Bournemouth. They remain on the attack, leading by a goal to nil away at West Ham.
Good defending there by Mavropanos. He's inside the 6 yard box. Good positioning. Gets a solid head on it to move that ball out for a goal kick, for a corner kick.
So the corner is going to be taken by Alex Scott. This is left-hand side as Bournemouth come forward. We're almost midway through the first half. A very busy six-yard box awaiting this as the attempted flick onto the front post flicks up and over the top. And I think it was Ryan Christie, was it? Yes, Ryan Christie, who tried to stoop down low, flick the header directly backwards. Difficult technique. And all he could do was land it onto the roof of the net.
Yeah, it's difficult. The ball's been whipped in quite low with a lot of pace. He's trying to do his best to get underneath it to flick it hard. A really, really difficult skill.
So West Ham, who've won 6 of the last 10 Premier League games, they've taken a lot of points. They are trailing here though at home tonight as the offside flag is raised. Suchek in an offside position as he flicks the ball forward there. So far tonight, West Ham's attack not really hitting much cohesion. And that is going to be a conundrum for David Moyes to try and put right. He's got plenty of time. He's got three quarters of this game to go, but West Ham aren't threatening. They aren't baring their teeth yet.
No, they're not able to get any sort of possession or you know, they're looking to pass the ball out to Kudos, which effectively is where their attacking threat is. But when he gets the ball, they've got two Bournemouth players on him, and there's no movement. There's only Bowen that can run in behind. So it's a real tricky one for David Moyes to start thinking about, because this shape at the moment is not working for them. Ward-Prowse is sort of out on the left-hand side. He's not been able to get on the ball at all. And Kudos is their only attacking threat, and it's Bournemouth that are winning all of the second balls there. The way that they're passing through the lines is making it really hard for West Ham to get any sort of control in the game.
Here's Semenyo for Bournemouth, far side of the pitch from us, the right hand side as Bournemouth come forward into the midfield to Lewis Cook. What is his 300th appearance for the club? A significant milestone for a player who's had bad injury problems in his career. It's great to see him reach 300 games for Bournemouth. Back to the goalkeeper, Neto, wearing bright, luminous pink, and he plays an accurate pass out to the far side to Adam Smith. Bournemouth very relaxed in possession. Ball into the midfield. Controlled by Christie. He's got two defenders around. Oh, he's done really well there, Ryan Christie, to get away. And then plays the pass just overcooked out towards Tavernier. That was almost perfect. Brilliant play initially from the Bournemouth midfielder, and then he'll be disappointed not to have executed the pass a bit better.
Yeah, he's great feet in the middle of the park. He's got away from Alvarez and Phillips. Just got a little bit giddy after that. He's tried to ping it out to Tavernier on this left-hand side and just misplaced that and straight out of play, unfortunately.
Yeah, giddy is a very good word. The adrenaline was pumping there. He was thinking, right, I'm on this, and he's just overcooked the pass. Another free kick to Bournemouth. This time Souček involved again. Fouling Cook. Free kick has been taken quickly. Christie on the ball for Bournemouth. Gives it to Tavernier. This is midway into West Ham territory. Wide out on the left-hand side. Johnson slips. Tavernier sees his opportunity. Lunges in. Last touch comes off him. And that goes out for a throw. Throw into West Ham. Right full-back position. Johnson, who's in deputising for the suspended so far, takes it. But they've given the ball away again, West Ham. And Scott plays it into the penalty area low. Solanke can't make it stick. Tavernier can't get the ball either. Johnson has it. Penned in a tight corner. Tries to clear away towards Kudos. Kudos wrestling for position. Wins a throw-in for his team. But West Ham are finding it very hard to break out of their own half. 1-0 they trail.
They are. He's down here on the right-hand side. Johnson's got the ball. He's under so much pressure from Tavernier. The only thing he's to do is hit up the line, and Kudos just uses his strength to at least get a throw-in for his team. But there's nothing else on for them at the moment.
West Ham nil, Bournemouth 1. You can hear the dissatisfaction of West Ham fans in the background. Smith rolls it back for Bournemouth from the halfway line all the way to the goalkeeper, Neto. This game panning out very well so far for Antonio Areola's team. Neto gives it short to Cook just in the D of the penalty area. Now to Ilya Zabanyi, who's the only Bournemouth player to have featured in every minute of the Premier League this season. His clearance has given up possession. Alvarez has it in the midfield for West Ham. Turns 180 degrees inside the centre circle, and then Ward-Prowse plays it to Emerson on the left-hand side. This is all still in the central third of the pitch. Bowen drops deep. Back to Calvin Phillips on his West Ham debut, the new loan signing for the rest of this season from Manchester City. Nice crossfield ball there from Phillips. That will have done his confidence the world of good. He picked out Ben Johnson, but there's no way unto attack from West Ham for there, and they retreat back into their own half again.
Bournemouth are defending really well. You just look, every time the ball gets anywhere near the Bournemouth half, there's the press, it's high. They're tracking back. You know, Johnson's up on this right-hand side for West Ham, but Tavernier's right out. Every time he gets the ball, he's closing him down, he's making him go back, and it's really difficult for West Ham to do anything.
Bowen tries to lead the line again, but Zabanyi sweeps across in front of his own penalty area, and nothing fancy from the Ukrainian defender. He nods it out for a throw into West Ham, which Kudos has taken quickly and gets it back from Jared Bowen. Crossing position on the right-hand side for the home team. Johnson to Bowen. Edge of the penalty area now is Alvarez. They're working their way slightly infield. Back out to the right wing again. Kudos looking for the angle to send in across, but he's closed down by Kelly. And that goes out for a throw-in to West Ham as Bournemouth continue to defend well. The throw is taken to Kudos. He takes on Kelly. Can't get around the big, tall left back. Bournemouth have regained possession. Tavernier will go long over the top for Solanke to chase after, but it's comfortably chested down by Kurt Zouma, and West Ham regain possession again on the halfway line.
Yeah, it's when Kudos is getting it out wide. He's gone to get the ball from Johnson on the throw-in, but Bowen's the one that receives it and passes it back, and then you've got Bowen and Kudos out on the touchline looking to put a cross in, and the only person in the box is then Souček. So it's really hard for them to look up and put a ball in when you've got four Bournemouth defenders with just one West Ham player. So they're finding it really difficult to actually get any sort of attacking threat going at the moment. And the pace and power from Bournemouth when they go forward is causing a lot of issues for Zouma and Mavropanos at the moment.
If you're just joining our coverage here on Five Line Sports Extra, early goal tonight has put Bournemouth in front. Dominic Solanke with his 15th goal in all competitions, his 13th in the Premier League. Only Haaland and Salah have scored more. And he took advantage of a mistake under pressure by Calvin Phillips just minutes into his West Ham debut. Challenged by Semenyo. Possession played, because it was a back pass from Phillips, it played Solanke onside, and he made no mistake, one-on-one with the goalkeeper. West Ham have never really recovered in this game from that early setback, and they are yet to produce any sort of a dangerous attempted goal to threaten the Bournemouth goalkeeper Neto. But a long way to go.
I think David Moyes will be looking at this thinking, you know, how are we going to change this? He's already probably starting to think, you know, at half time, what am I going to be saying to these players? How am I going to change it? Is it the shape? Because is it Ward-Prowse out on that left hand side? Do we need to try and get him inside a little bit to get him on the ball? Is Souček, is his position, is he too close to Bowen? Does he need to come back in? Because there's a lot of space on that midfield just in behind where he is, but in front of Phillips and Alvarez to Bournemouth for picking up the ball. So there's a lot of tactical switches that Moyes needs to actually have a little look at.
David Moyes, in his long managerial career, he's only ever once lost a Premier League game to Bournemouth, and that was back when he was Sunderland manager, 2017. His West Ham team here trailing by a goal to nil with almost exactly half an hour played at London Stadium, where West Ham are unbeaten in the last five Premier League games here. Thrown by Smith on the far side, flicked on by Semenyo, who gets it back again. He's sometimes looks a bit gainly, he's got the spidery legs, Semenyo, but he is very difficult to shuffle off the ball. You think he's lost it, and he stretches out again and he holds on to it. Here he is running against James Ward-Prowse over the halfway line for Bournemouth, waits for the contact to come from behind, and down he goes. And he's done quite well there to win the free kick for Bournemouth. Free kick to the visitors near the sideline, midway into the West Ham half. Bournemouth who lead 1-0.
Yeah, it's definitely a foul there, Alvarez. Semenya knows exactly what he's doing. He's getting his body in. He's already showed that he's got great strength. So he's just got his body in front of Alvarez, who's just pushed him right in the back. And he's got his team another free kick. But for West Ham, you mentioned about, you know, at the moment with David Moyes, the thing with West Ham is they're only a set piece away from getting back into this game. They've got such a threat from set pieces with Ward-Prowse. So any opportunity for them is Bournemouth have to be on guard.
Bournemouth on the attack. Smith gives it to Tavernier. This is 5 or 6 yards on the byline, right hand side. Back out to Alex Scott, who's had some good touches. That's a lovely ball. Tavernier tries to put it back, and too many defenders in there. It ricochets into the arms of Areola, but there was a threat about that Bournemouth attack. Areola bowls it out to Ben Johnson, who tries a little Ronaldo-style chop on the halfway line that doesn't work. More groans from West Ham fans. Alvarez manages to out-muscle Alex Scott and win back possession for his team. West Ham come over the halfway line again, and a bit of a roar of encouragement beginning to seep around London Stadium as the West Ham fans realise that their team needs that extra bit of support in these circumstances now, trailing by a goal to nil to Bournemouth at home.
Yeah, they do, but Alvarez, he just had that little spark. He's just won a 50-50 in the middle of the park, which the West Ham fans, you know, they needed that. They needed to show a bit of character from these players, and that's what Alvarez does. He, you know, he goes about his business. He's very strong in that middle of the park. He likes to put his body on the line, and that's what you need sometimes when you're not playing very well. You need one player to make a good challenge, and then it revitalises everyone, and especially gets the fans on side.
Throw in for West Ham. This is levelled with the edge of the penalty area of the attack down the right hand side. Mavropanos has given himself the big run up, but disappointing throw. His teammates had all backed away expecting a long distance throw. It came in very short, must have slipped out of his fingers or something. There's a foul on Calvin Phillips by Alex Scott, and West Ham get an attacking set piece midway inside Bournemouth territory.
I do hope the ball did slip out of his hands, because otherwise that is it's the shortest long throw I've seen. But this is what we were saying about set pieces. Now you've got Ward-Prowse on the right hand side, he can deliver a ball, and he's got Alvarez, Zouma, Mavropanos, Souček in the box.
There's a line of West Ham players who are all standing in ostensibly offside positions. Ball doesn't reach them anyways. It comes in a little bit of a disappointing delivery by James Ward-Prowse's standards. It ends up in the arms of the goalkeeper, and that sort of sums up West Ham and their night here. Things that you expect of them just aren't happening at the moment.
Yeah, that is something that you don't see every day. A Ward-Prowse free kick that's not on the money. You know, that's something that West Ham have been able to rely on heavily, especially, you know, this season. And that was a really disappointing free kick, because they haven't been able to create anything. So a moment like that, where you can put the ball into the box unopposed, is huge. And they need to make sure that they take these chances.
This is Five Live Sports Extra from the BBC. We have played 33 minutes now at London Stadium. Dominic Solanke's early call separating the sides. Mavropanos sprinting back, nothing fancy, puts the ball out of play for a throw-in that will keep Bournemouth on the attack. This is level with the edge of the penalty area. They attack down the right-hand side. Alex Scott makes himself available. Across from Scott, from the right, is too close to the goalkeeper and into the gloves of Alphonse Areola. West Ham need it down the other end. The goalkeeper goes long. First time Tonali's really pumped it. Looking for Kudos. Well policed by Lloyd Kelly, who heads it out for a throw into West Ham. Throw-in's taken quickly by Ben Johnson. He gets the ball back again from Edson Álvarez. Álvarez has missed the last two games before tonight with a calf injury. Now Kurt Zouma has it near the centre circle. James Ward-Prowse has just dropped deep, helping it on to Emerson Palmieri on the far side. Emerson, who's played all but one of West Ham's Premier League games this season, he's been busy too. He's made more tackles than any of his teammates this season in the Premier League. Calvin Phillips on his debut has picked it up here and will bring it closer to the Bournemouth penalty area down the left-hand side. Souček receives near the penalty area, trying to give it to Bowen. West Ham are holding on to the ball here. Then it's been given away and more groans. Jared Bowen has given possession to Antoine Semenyo, who will break with long strides into the West Ham half, away to our left-hand side, and he drags Álvarez across to the middle, who slides in and puts it out for a throw.
They're set up, Bournemouth, there. They've all got back. They've defended really well. His first opportunity, West Ham actually had a bit of possession, and when there's a few numbers forward, and as soon as they lose the ball, Jared Bowen, just give it away, Semenya. He's driving forward up the pitch. He's using his pace. He gets down to the corner where Álvarez makes it a really good challenge, but that's what West Ham need to be wary of, because Bournemouth have got such pace going forward. Tavernier, Semenya and Solanke up top, they're really, really sharp. They use the ball really well as they pass through the lines, and it's going to be difficult to make sure that when they do try and get forward, that they keep that door closed at the back.
Here's an opportunity. Solanke into Semenyo. What a save by Areola. Semenyo was 10 yards out. It was point blank, and Alphonse Areola has prevented Bournemouth from taking a 2-goal lead here. That was too easy. Solanke was able to draw the defence and roll it in front of Semenyo. Bournemouth should be 2-0 in front.
He's got to score. Got to score. It's, again, West Ham just sloppy play in the middle of the park. Álvarez trying to let it go through his legs, and it's one touch straight into Solanke, who lays on to Semenya, who's inside the box, has a touch, and he's got to score. A great save by Areola. It is a great save, point blank range, but he should be scored. It should be 2-0 to Bournemouth.
Antoine Semenya, who's got 3 Premier League goals this season, scored against Aston Villa in December. I have to say, the way this game has started, had Bournemouth taken a 2-goal lead ahead of half time, you would worry for West Ham and their attempts to get back in it. As it is, that might be a wake-up spark for David Moyes' team now, as Johnson controls near the halfway line, gives it infield to Edson Álvarez. He tries to play one over the top, and again, there's no one making the run. Bowen had turned and wanted it to feet. It's been played over the top of him. There's no one running onto it, and you can see why West Ham United fans are frustrated at that, with 8 minutes of normal time to go to the break.
Yeah, it's one of them that, Bowen's thinking to come in short, Álvarez has put it over the top, but the whole link-up play, the communication between the West Ham players at the moment, it's not clicking. I don't think everyone's comfortable in their positions. Ward-Prowse is trying his best to get on the ball, but he's having to come really deep and narrow, so then there's effectively no one out on the left-hand side for West Ham. Kudus is trying to get in the game. He's been the one that they've kept on looking for, that diag out to this right-hand side, but it's been really difficult to keep hold of the ball with the way that Bournemouth have been defended.
West Ham looking a little bit raggled, a little bit lacking in a plan, which will be frustrating David Moyes. When you look at the games that Bournemouth have played recently, the games they've lost has been against the very best teams in the land. They were beaten by Liverpool, beaten by Spurs, beaten by Manchester City, beaten by Liverpool in the League Cup as well. They were beaten by Arsenal. Back over the last few months, only those top sides have been able to beat them. Here's the ball in there. Bowen tries to hit it. Kudos to right in front of the goalkeeper. And somehow West Ham haven't scored. That's hands down West Ham's best opportunity of the evening. With 7 minutes to go to the break. Cross in from the left-hand side. And Bowen's going to try and come again here. Gets the ball inside the penalty area. Taking on Zabarnyi. Tries to cross it in. It comes off the defender. It looks like that might have gone out of play. Play on, though, says the referee. Bowen get it back again. Drones on the West Ham fans. And it's cleared out for a throw-in on the far side by Smith. And that will be a throw-in to Bournemouth and a chance to clear their lines. But we get a chance to see the replay of that West Ham opportunity. Bowen and Kudus either of them could have scored. Neto did well.
It's their first opportunity. They got the ball wide into a great position to cross, and it was Ward-Prowse, and he, as we mentioned, his delivery, and it was on the money this time, and it was Bowen. He just needed a flick. The keeper stood up, made a great save, but Bowen's just trying to guide it in. He's got a flick onto it, but great save. Really good save. That's their best opportunity so far, West Ham.
It feels like West Ham have to get Ward-Prowse on the ball in attacking positions more often. Suchek here has given a nice touch to Emerson. He breaks forward down the left-hand side, tries to send in the cross, which it's Adam Smith. And the ball goes out of play for a throw into West Ham. Down by the corner flag, they attack on the left-hand side. Just one or two green shoots from West Ham of recovery in these closing stages of the first half. Emerson plays the ball back to Adson Alvarez. He looks up to see who's in space and picks out Ben Johnson. Johnson midway inside the Bournemouth half. Now Kudos picks it up. Dancing his way around Kelly. Brilliant from Kudos. Delivers the ball in, and it's headed by Socek over the crossbar. It's going to be a goal kick to Bournemouth. Socek slow to get back to his feet. Suddenly West Ham have woken up in the game and are beginning to make chances.
It's one-on-one again. You want Kudos. Give him the ball 1v1. And he does it. This time he goes down the line on his right foot. Puts a really good ball in behind everyone. And it's Suchek that gets his head on it. But he's stretching and he just heads it over the bar. But again, Kudos. Get Kudos. Ward-Prowse. And you give them the chance to take someone on or get a delivery into the box, and they will produce. And this is the only time that Bournemouth have felt a little bit under pressure in this first half.
West Ham have just flicked a switch and found a bit of attacking momentum. David Moyes will hope they can keep this up. They'll be kicking off in 5 minutes' time at Molineux. Wolves against Manchester United is the one other Premier League game this evening. There will be commentary of that match available over on our sister station 5.5. Actually, we will join the early stages of that game during halftime here on Sports Extra at London Stadium. Alphonse Areola, French goalkeeper, wearing old green, plays it out from the edge of his area towards the halfway line, where Suchek is beaten in the air by Senesi. And then down goes Solanke, looking for a free kick on the edge of the West Ham penalty area, but the referee says no and play on. Johnson has it for West Ham, but tackled well too by Tavernier, and Bournemouth win it back again. They've been very resilient, Bournemouth. They lose the ball, they work very hard, and invariably they win it back quickly. This is James Ward-Prowse, though, collecting possession midway inside his own half. Gives it to the left to Emerson. Emerson back to James Ward-Prowse and back to the Italian international. Much better from West Ham as they break up towards Davina. But that wasn't a good choice of pass. Emerson nearly lost possession there. He gave it to Edson Alvarez, who was being closely marked. Shades of the opening goal there, just that it wasn't on the edge of their own penalty area. Kudos is fouled by Lloyd Kelly. Free kick to West Ham, who wanted to take the free kick quickly. And groans of dissatisfaction from West Ham fans, but the reason the referee has brought it back is because the ball wasn't stationary, it was a rolling ball when the free kick had been taken. Now it's taken properly. Kudos has given two defenders the slip, passes it to the right hand side to Ben Johnson. West Ham are finishing this second first half well, but the cross comes in behind James Ward-Prowse. He'll sprint out to keep it in play by the sideline on the left, and he's played a lovely ball for Emerson, delivers into the penalty area. Bournemouth are under pressure now. Calvin Phillips lunges for it on the edge of the Bournemouth penalty area, but can't get there. Christie will clear it away for Bournemouth. Tavernier's first touch is ahead of him, but in behind to Johnson, who'll recover well, and West Ham regain possession, and the game has just clicked a different gear now as we approach half time.
I know David Moyes will be thinking, Kai, now I need a lot of extra time in this first half. It's the first time that they've actually had a bit of possession and looked like they're on the attack. It was Kudos again. He's the man at the moment to get on the ball in the middle of the park. He's received the ball from that free kick. He's turned and he's just put his head down and sprinted between two Bournemouth players and then got it wide to Johnson, who put the cross in. It just vacated everyone had just gone a bit too close to the goalkeeper. It's gone behind them, but that's this West Ham team. They've got to get going, but Bournemouth just they can break you down. They really can. They've got good possession. As soon as they win the ball, they can break with pace, and that's what they've been doing.
Bournemouth, who haven't won in the last five Premier League meetings with West Ham, across from the left from Socek, is very calmly chested back by Lloyd Kelly to his goalkeeper, Neto. The last time Bournemouth beat tonight's opponents was a 2-0 home win just over 5 years ago, January 2019. Callum Wilson and Josh King scored the goals for Eddie Howe's side, as it was back then, Bournemouth. It's very much Antoni Areola's team now. And his methods are beginning to bear fruit. And a Bournemouth team who, you know, it was one of the big stories back end of last season, how Gary O'Neill was relieved from his duties. But Iriola is showing there's a bit of method to the madness, and his methods are proving to be very effective. Here is Kelly playing the ball forward to Solanke, who's onside. Receives it inside the penalty area. Now, Tavernier, it opens up for him, and Alphonse Areola makes a great save again. Another big chance for Bournemouth. And West Ham are living very, very dangerously. The flag goes up belatedly. I think that was from the earlier Solanke run. The assistant on the far side, Adam Nunn, just waited until it was completely dead, that challenge, before he raised his flag. But West Ham are allowing Bournemouth numerous chances here to get shots through on goal, and that has got to be of concern.
Yes, the original run by Solanke was offside, but it's just one ball over the top, and that's what we mentioned. But Areola has made an unbelievable save. I know it would have been done offside, but for him and the confidence, that's a great save. Down low this time, really good stop from Tavernier.
Yeah, it's two excellent stops from Alphonse Areola. He denied Antoine Semenyo earlier on. Now he's made another save there. With 20 seconds to go of normal time, ahead of half-time at London Stadium, and Bournemouth a little bit disappointed that they haven't stretched this lead and doubled it. And well, that would have landed West Ham in even hotter water. This is Edson Alvarez inside the centre circle. Gives it out to James Ward-Prowse on the left. Has a 1-2 with Soucek. Much better now. Bowen tried to lay it up, but that's not a good touch. And Smith gets it back initially for Bournemouth. Christie now picks it up. We've moved into stoppages, of which 2 minutes have been allocated. Here comes Mavropanos. Nice interception there. And he'll give it up to Soucek, who is increasingly moving forward, trying to lend support to Bowen in the middle. Cross on the right-hand side. Smith underneath it for Bournemouth. Hasn't fully cleared away. Christie has the wherewithal to take it down and flick a wonderful trick around the back of his standing leg. That was so composed by Christie. And Bournemouth come on the counter down the other end. And this is Semenyo breaking into the penalty area. Shoots, deflected out for a corner. Bournemouth exhilarating on the counter-attack, and they are banging on the door for a second goal tonight. As it stands, West Ham 0, Bournemouth 1 in stoppage time ahead of the break.
Yeah, and it all started from a lovely little flick at the edge of the box, but that's what we're saying about Bournemouth on the counter-attack. Solanke drives from the middle out to Semenyo on this right-hand side, cuts inside on his left foot. It's a great strike. It takes a deflection, I think, as of Emerson, but Areola has to make the save as well. It's dipping, and he puts it over the top of the bar for a corner.
Corner to Bournemouth, who lead thanks to Dominic Solanke's early goal tonight. Alex Scott prepares to take it. Left-hand side as they come forward. Most of the Bournemouth players are at the back post of where this comes. And it's headed away in the centre out by Mavropanos. It comes to Cook. Cook will dink it back into the penalty area, but cleared away by Ben Johnson. West Ham struggling to hold on to it in the midfield, and Bournemouth are going to get it back again here with Cook. Good energy under pressure from Kelvin Phillips on his West Ham debut, and then back to Zabani, who'll roll it back to the goalkeeper Adam Neto. Bournemouth have possession inside their final third. Smith to Cook, who's given it a good lash of a right boot up over the halfway line, but straight to Kurt Zouma. West Ham regained possession there. This is Kelvin Phillips to Emerson on the left-hand side. Plays it left-footed over the halfway line, chested down by Soucek. Edson Alvarez will pop it over the top. Bowen in pursuit, and Senesi, back covering from Bournemouth, is able to clear away. That is the final action of the first half, and you can hear the boos in the background. West Ham fans are not happy. Curious goal they gave away right at the start of this game when a poor pass to debutant Kelvin Phillips inside the penalty area saw him make a rushed clearance back to his goalkeeper, a back pass. Solanke was able to pounce from what looked ostensibly to be an offside position, but because it was a back pass, he was onside. Nothing Areola could do about that, but the French goalkeeper has made two other huge saves of the game, and there's no doubt that over the course of the 45 minutes, Bournemouth have been the better team. Matt Jarvis.
Yes, they have. They started so well. It's the press, how much energy they started with, and then after that, it's the way that they're so fluid through the lines, you know, from defence to midfield to strikers, and they've got that pace and power up top that is going to hurt any defence. But West Ham, it's the last 5 minutes, really. They didn't get going until the 40th minute. And then once they did, they get it wide, and it's Ward-Prowse on the ball and it's Kudos on the ball. They're the two players they need to get on the ball that can produce some sort of magic. And it was Bowen with the flick on Ward-Prowse's cross, and then Soucek from Kudos's one. But apart from that, it was all Bournemouth.
Yeah, you might remember West Ham were 1-0 down at half-time against Tottenham in December. That was a game they came back to win. So David Moyes will know this isn't over yet, but it's a bit of a rarity. Only the third time this season that West Ham have conceded a goal in the first half of a Premier League game at home. We will see if they can get back into it, or can indeed Bournemouth go on and claim the 3 points this evening. So second half coverage to come here on BBC Radio 5 Sports Extra. To keep you entertained over halftime, we're going to join our colleagues on 5 Live. We're going to wing our way to Molineux and join commentary of Wolves against Manchester United. We will be back here for the second half.
Gomez is there as well, and one or two others. And here now is Garnacho from Manchester United. And in it goes to the penalty area by Dalot. Little turn just outside the penalty. It's 6 yard area, played back to Rashford. And wouldn't you believe it? Marcus Rashford puts Manchester United ahead. After 4 minutes, attack by Hoyland. The little ball slipped back to Rashford. And Marcus Rashford, for all the controversy, should he be in the starting lineup? Should it be disciplined more by Erik ten Hag, has fired Manchester United ahead, just as he did here last season.
Well, he's been in the headlines for all the wrong reasons, but it's taken him 4 minutes tonight to get on the score sheet. And didn't you just know it was coming? Didn't you know it was going to be Marcus Rashford? It comes from the right-hand side. Dalot doing some excellent work. Fires a cross across the box, and Hoyland's got his back to goal, surrounded by two Wolves centre-halves. Does really, really well. The ball gets away from him a little bit. Looks up, who's there on the edge of the box? Marcus Rashford opens his right foot, curls it into Jose Sarr's left-hand top corner. Manchester United and Marcus Rashford could not wish for a better start to this game.
Cleverly used the positioning of two Wolves defenders as well. Bent the ball around them, and that meant the goalkeeper, the vision of Jose Sarr, was obscured by his own men. It's a lovely finish, but the selfless role in the goal of Rasmus Hoyland needs to be praised as well.
Absolutely, he's been very good at that. We talked pre-game with Steve in the show about his role off the ball as well, and what he brings to this team and the qualities that he has. He may not be prolific yet, but there's potential there. But he showed there what he does for this team. He held the ball up in a dangerous area, saw Marcus Rashford, very, very unselfishly set up Manchester United and Marcus Rashford to go 1-0 up.
Missed the bus in advance of the game here last year. Dropped to the bench, came off it, scored. Missed training, plays today from the start, scores again. And Manchester United lead. Here's Lisandro Martinez away to Dalot. And Manchester United knew they came into this under pressure from Wolverhampton Wanderers, who could have crept above them in the table. But it's not just about Man United here tonight, it's about this Wolverhampton Wanderers team with talent like Neto in the side, and he's on the ball and he sprays it from deep inside his own halfway towards the right hand side. And here comes Totti Gomez now back towards the halfway line, and on that halfway line Tommy Doyle is there. Big Manchester connection, comes from the city, on loan from Manchester City of course. Back it goes then to Jose Sarr, all in pink as usual, the Wolves goalkeeper, who side foots it away, right foot away towards the far touchline, right hand side. And the flyer that is Nelson Semedo on the ball. Semedo back to Maximilian Kilmer. He learned his football playing futsal as a youngster. Indeed, represented his country in that side of the sport. Doyle. A rude awakening for Wolverhampton Wanderers as Manchester United score early and lead 1-0 on 5 Live. Now Dawson away towards the right side again. Wolverhampton Wanderers pick it up and look for Semedo. 10 yards inside the Manchester United half. Nothing comes of it, so they go back into their own half of the field. And Dawson, 12 yards outside his own penalty area, plumb dead centre, just trots away with the ball and drops it at the feet of Max Kilmer.
Yeah, they're just trying to get hold of the ball, Wolves. They're just trying to recoup after the early shock that they've had. Manchester United started this game extremely well. Started on the front foot, great opportunity. Marcus Rashford took the chance. And this is the first little bit of possession that Wolves have actually had venturing into the Manchester United half.
And this is a decent burst forward by Cunha, but he lost possession. Hasn't set the world on fire since the big move from Atletico Madrid, improved of late. And now Hoyland goes down, no free kick given for Manchester United. And Wolves will bring it away with Semedo, who's already covered 25 yards. He's deep inside the Manchester United half now. Drops it at the feet of Neto, coming in off the right-hand side. Checks back again, looking for a pass. Allowed to roll 360 degrees. The gloved Wolverhampton Wanderers Portuguese international plays it away then towards this near side. And Wolverhampton Wanderers in control of the ball with Doyle to the left-hand touchline. And Doherty cut kicks it into the box. Neto facing away from goal, being pushed away from goal by Lisandro Martinez. Goal kick.
He's almost got a free role in that Wolves side, Neto, hasn't he? I mean, they've played pretty structured with the back three, three centre-halves, the two wing-backs and the two city midfielders, and it's Bellegarde and Neto. They're supposed to play either side of Cunha, but Neto's that good. He's given a free role. He pops up all over the pitch. He's very, very important in their ball rotation and the keeping of possession.
1-0 to Manchester United. Bournemouth 1 up at West Ham United. What a week of sport we've had for you on 5 Live continues as well. France against Ireland, the big Six Nations opener. Is at 8 o'clock on tomorrow night, the Rugby Union Daily Podcast on BBC Sounds as well. I'll give you more details of the weekend programmes as we go on through the night. Here's Lisandro Martinez, so important for Manchester United, and he's back in the side on the 14th of January after 3 months out with his foot problem, his second big injury he's had since moving from Ajax. He has been a success, and Martinez looks forward then, looks for the run of Bruno Fernandes, but it's too long and Nelson Semedo clears down that left hand side. Temperatures dropping at Molineux. Manchester United though leading by 1-0. The goal scored then early on in the game by Marcus Rashford. United have possession halfway line. Casemiro calmly rolls it to his left hand side. Martinez, typical, these roll those sleeves up Martinez, angles a pass away to the wily Casemiro on that far side. 18 trophies as a Real Madrid player, including 5 Champions Leagues. United have it. Hoyland inside the Wolverhampton Wanderers half, rolls away from his marker, plays back to Kobbie Mainoo, and to his left here's Fernandes. Fernandes has Rashford, left corner of the penalty area. Manchester United progressive, Rashford into the box. Fernandes had to stretch to play back to Casemiro, and he bends the shot, but it's a little bit flat and a little bit wayward and a little bit wide, and it's a goal kick.
They look sharp tonight, Manchester United, don't they? They look at it. We've seen them so many times this season where they've looked off the pace, but they started the game very, very well, and Marcus Rashford in particular. We all wondered whether, one, he would start, and two, how he would play when and if he did, and he's been excellent right from the start. I mean, his goal's obviously going to help him, but he looks sharp. He's pressing now as we speak. He looks quick. And he looks like he wants to be there tonight, which he hasn't done at times this season.
You know, Ten Hag looks more relaxed down there on the touchline with his big padded overcoat and his grey beanie hat down there as well. Gary O'Neill comes to the edge of his technical area. Again with a padded coat, but that one is open, bareheaded. And he still looks as if he's fit enough to play, Gary O'Neill, and he was a very decent footballer. Player of the season at Portsmouth, the player of the season at Norwich later on. He won promotion at QPR and West Ham. Good spell at Bristol City. I seem to remember he was popular down there. And it's going to be a throw for West Ham on the right hand, for Wolverhampton Wanderers on the right hand side with Semedo. Infield it goes to Doyle. Manchester United leading 1-0 through this man. On that left hand side, Rashford will take the throw in for them. It was won by Kobbie Mainoo, who gets around the field of play. He's only 18 years of age. It's his 6th start in a row. He has brought that energy into that area.
And he's also got the defensive capabilities as well. Alongside Casemiro, he sits there in the holding midfield role, but he's got the ability to go forward. But with those two behind them, the likes of Garnacho, Fernandes and Rashford, Rashford playing on the left tonight, Garnacho on the right, Fernandes in his usual number 10 role, they know that they've got real quality and defensive stability behind them should they get caught in the final third.
Gallo to Mainoo. A little bit overambitious in the pass through to Garnacho. He's young, he will make mistakes, and he'll have lull periods as well, flat periods in these next couple of years. And he goes off the ball a little bit, but he's certainly a big name for the future for me. Now Semedo has it for Wolverhampton Wanderers on the halfway line. Big balloon, expansive crossfield ball, accurately played for Wolves. They've got a chance here, they get a cross into the penalty area. This is a dangerous run. And then the cross came to nothing in the end because Matheus Cunha lost his footing, I think, there, Robbo, and he just slipped it through into Onana.
Just slipped at the vital stage, didn't he? He does really well on this left-hand side. His first touch goes into the box, very, very direct, gets in a position where Dalot can't touch him, and just as he goes to strike, he loses his footing and almost strikes the ball with his standing foot. He does, and it comes off Dalot quite easily and comfortably into the arms of Onana. But early on in that move there, when the long ball, the crossfield ball from Semedo came, it was very, very interesting to see Marcus Rashford. He trekked 30, 40, 50 yards, tracking back into his own half, and we've not seen him do that too often this season.
Body language hasn't been great at some stages of the season now. Bruno Fernandes has gone down. He had a heavy fall there from an aerial challenge.
He's gone. Only missed a couple of games, you know, since the World Cup in Qatar. Bruno Fernandes, a long year, 2023 was for him. So we've got a momentary pause. He does look up for it tonight. Marcus Rashford certainly is having a word there with Hoyland. Rasmus Hoyland may not have got the goals his work rate has deserved. 8 for Manchester United. 3 in his last 5. Hasn't scored a word, I think, in the Premier League yet. But he's certainly trying to work on this understanding with Marcus Rashford out there at this moment in time. And it is a chilly night. There's one or two people who travelled up from the south who thought that spring had come because the daffodils are starting to bloom, and they didn't bring a big coat or a jumper today. I would describe those people as idiots. And you're sitting next to one right now, actually, Robbo, I have to say.
I was going to say, is that a very good description of yourself, Jonathan? Yeah. Because you don't look the warmest this evening, to be honest. You see, us northerners don't. We don't even own a big coat.
Wolves have it on the left-hand side, that with Totti. Does like to get forward from that centre-foot, centre-half position on the left. Overzealous in the challenge, gives away a free kick right in front of Ten Hag. 1-0 to Manchester United. Casemiro has it. Came to English football late. He turns 32 later this month. But it is a joy to see him. Hasn't been at his best this season compared to last. It would have been more joyous had he come a little bit earlier, but he was doing other things with Real Madrid. Coby made it. Deep inside his own half. Then tried a little reverse ball down the line to Casemiro. It was too tight. Wolves had a throw. And they're enjoying a little bit of possession here now. Cunha has it, tried to spread the ball away to Neto. It was deflected kindly for Manchester United. And Manu finds Hoyland to his left. Bruno Fernandes. On it goes. Shaw has crept into the Wolves' half. Left-hand side finds Marcus Rashford. Has Shaw on the overlap. Perfectly timed ball. Was it? He's pulled the cross back into the middle. Wolves fully had gone out of play. Cleared to Casemiro. And he skied the shot well wide into the depths of the Sir Jack Hayward stand away to our right-hand side goal kick.
Brilliant again by Marcus Rashford. He holds the line on that left-hand side. He gets right out onto the touchline. Luke Shaw's in possession. Rashford times his run perfectly. Shaw just slips it into Rashford. He's running one-on-one at Semedo. He runs past him, and then he times his pass back to Luke Shaw to perfection. It almost stops on the byline. Shaw just hooks his foot round it, and there's no Manchester United player in the box. But the understanding between Shaw and Rashford is clearly there already.
Sorry, Paul. Just breaking news for you. BBC Sport understands Joe Hodge was on the bench for Wolves tonight. Will join QPR on loan for the rest of the season after this game.
Does Joe Hodge know that if he's sat on the bench?
I wonder whether Gary O'Neill's told him. Gary O'Neill was a QPR player himself back in 13, 14, part of a promotion-winning side. Here's Cunha. Cunha now to his right. Neto just outside the D. Semedo arriving. Too much weight on the pass. Had to veer to his right. Gets the cross back in. Deflected away off Shaw for a corner kick. Really, pressing now.
Really good by Neto. He just showed his quality there. Picked up the ball in a really dangerous position on the edge of the 18-yard box. Many would have panicked and looked to get rid of the ball quickly, but he didn't. He looked up and he turned. Saw Semedo in a really good position down the right-hand side. Slipped his fullback in, who's won his team a corner.
Corner for Wolves. Harry Lamina is in there for them. Kilman is up from the back. So to Dawson, who's rolling around to the far side of the penalty to get that header back into the six-yard area. Nana comes very calmly and collects, catches, looks to clear away early, can't do so, he just holds on to the ball. Let me tell you about our Saturday games for you on 5-5. Newcastle against Luton, Premier League at 3 o'clock, but we'll have the full goal service as well across the country, and Dennis does a brilliant job with that. And then the 5:30 kickoff for you is Sheffield United against Aston Villa. Onana.
So Jonathan Pearce continuing over on our sister station 5 Live, but here on Sports Extra we are just back underway at London Stadium. West Ham United 0, Bournemouth 1, the early goal from Dominic Solanke, and no changes on either side over half time. So West Ham now playing from right to left as we look down in the claret and blue. Bournemouth in their away strip, sort of a pale light blue, playing from left to right. West Ham goalkeeper Areola playing behind a back four of Ben Johnson, Kurt Zouma, Dinos Mavropanos and Emerson Palmieri. In the midfield, Calvin Phillips and Edson Alvarez, with Thomas Suchek pushing forward, James Ward-Prowse on the left, Mohamed Kudus on the right, and Jared Bowen, the central striker, through the middle. The Bournemouth team, Neto the goalkeeper, back four Smith, Zabani, Sinisi and Kelly, Lewis Cook and Christie holding in midfield, Semenya wide right, Tavernier wide left, Alex Scott in the middle and Dominic Solanke, who got the goal, leading the line up front. Matt Jarvis is alongside me. Big 45 minutes to come here for David Moyes, Matt.
Yeah, huge 45. But I think I've just quickly looked now, and I think the David Moyes has made a little tactical switch, and Ward-Prowse is now where Souček was in the first half. You got Alvarez is sitting, you got Ward-Prowse in the top of the point, and you got Souček on the right and Phillips on this left-hand side, which for me, you know, Souček couldn't get in the game in that first half, and every time Ward-Prowse got the ball, he looked to try and make things happen, but he was out on this left-hand side. So, you know, a positive switch for West Ham. We're trying to get Ward-Prowse down the middle on the ball, but there's a lot of work to do in this second half because they were nowhere near it in that first half. Bournemouth on top the whole 40 minutes, really. West Ham only come alive in the last five, so a big second half.
Yes, Ward-Prowse was one of the brighter sparks for West Ham. We mentioned in the commentary they need to get him on the ball a little bit more. This new central location should allow him a bit more possession. As Kudos gets the ball on the far side of the pitch from us, but he's right up against the touchline and he spills off the field, and that's a throw-in to Bournemouth. Bournemouth, through the last four times in the Premier League that they've been leading at half-time, they haven't lost, but they're not infallible in that regard. You go back to October, Bournemouth had a half-time lead against Wolves and they did end up losing that game by 2-1, so there could still be a few twists in the tail. If you weren't with our coverage in the first half, Semenyo had a really good opportunity, Tavernier too, and two excellent saves from Alphonse Areola kept Bournemouth at bay and kept them just to that one goal advantage that they hold as things stand. Zabani here rolls it back to Neto, away in the distance on the left-hand side. And his right-footed clearance up towards Dominic Solanke, who gets up and wins the header well in the air. He was jumping with Ben Johnson, and Solanke has hurt himself. I don't know if it was the heavy fall there or whether he's been caught in the head as he challenged. Because it is a head injury, the referee is obliged to hold up play. And we're going to see if Dominic Solanke needs any treatment here. It just looks like he's holding his jaw, his chin, somewhere around there as he slowly gets back to his feet.
Yeah, looks like a sore one. He's both players have come into it. I think he's just caught his face on Ben Johnson's face as well. He just might have could have bit his tongue or something as well. He looks in a bit of pain, but I'm sure he'll be all right. He's going to run it off here. He's got an opportunity to add to his tally for this second half.
Play back underway. Solanke okay to continue. Both teams still with 11 on the pitch. Here is Alex Scott on the halfway line for Bournemouth. Gives it back to Lloyd Kelly, who's done well in this game so far against Kudos. Kudos, who's been hot property for West Ham in recent months. He's just back tonight from the African Cup of Nations. He beat Kelly once to deliver a good cross on the right-hand side, but otherwise Kelly has got the better of their one-on-one battles in this game so far. Bowen, who has had a few opportunities in the game, most notably a little flick-on attempt to the penalty area that he wasn't able to get clean purchase on from a James Ward-Prowse delivery. This is Zabani back to Neto once again, and there's a calmness about Bournemouth. They look comfortable in this lead. 1-0 to the visitors at London Stadium this Thursday night on Five Live Sports Extra. That's a good run towards the edge of the penalty area made by Tavernier. Then a low ball in by Scott. He was trying to pick out Solanke. Too many defenders back there and West Ham get it away. Kelly will come forward once again. Gives it short to Scott near the edge of the penalty area that Bournemouth are attacking. Scott is out by the sideline on the left-hand side. And Tavernier now, a little bit closer to the penalty area, is challenged by Edson Alvarez. The Mexican is very strong and he's won back possession for his team, but he is penned in by that corner flag right full-back position. Gives a little back heel to Ben Johnson. West Ham get it moving up to the halfway line, and that's where it breaks down and Sinisi wins it back for Bournemouth.
Yeah, I was going to go back to Kelly. I think he's defended Kudos extremely well because he's been the one player that West Ham been trying to get the ball to all the time, but he's dealt with him really well.
Here's James Ward-Prowse, attacking position on the right-hand side. He cuts it back for Kudos, more centrally now, well outside the penalty area though. Edson Alvarez on his left shoulder. To the left come West Ham to Emerson. Back in field again to Calvin Phillips, who has held this position more to the left-hand side since the resumption of play after half-time. Ward-Prowse gives it out to the right wing. This is Ben Johnson, sells a dummy of a cross, then gives it short to Kudos, still on the right-hand side. Here comes the left-footed delivery, into the middle, too high for Bowen, sails over them all, And it's got to be kept in play by Adam Smith, the Bournemouth right back. He'll clear it right footed up towards the halfway line where Kurt Zouma beats Solanke in the air and West Ham get it back again. You can see the machinations, West Ham trying to move through the gears, trying to get things clicking here. But Bournemouth are answering the questions that have been asked of them so far. This is Mavropanos chesting it down near the halfway line for West Ham. Gives it to his right-hand side to Ben Johnson. Now the direct ball forward, looking for Bowen. Jumping in the air up against the taller Zabarnyi. The Bournemouth man wins possession, but West Ham get it back immediately. Calvin Phillips near the halfway line turns and rolls it back to Kurt Zouma. The crowd have gone a little bit quiet here at London Stadium as they wait for some West Ham fireworks to arrive.
Yeah, it's Bournemouth again defending well. West Ham are keeping the ball, playing it round, but it's as soon as they get into the attacking third, that's where Bournemouth start to press. But it's making hard work, West Ham, of trying to get the attacking players in the game. And every time they do, you know, they're doubled up on or they're putting the cross in there like Kudos did. He whipped in a good ball into the box, but it's only Bowen really that's able to be in the box to get on the end of it. And Bournemouth are quite happy for that to happen and defending it really well.
7 minutes played of the second half. Neto in possession for Bournemouth. He's poor clearance this time. First time he's done that, he's given it away to Socek inside the Bournemouth half. Kudos now with the support of Alvarez, and a sliding, crunching tackle comes in from Senesi. Loose ball falls to Johnson, whose cross is again too high. And that's happened two or three times now in the second half already. West Ham get into decent positions, but not accurate enough with their delivery into the centre.
Yeah, it is a waste, because that opportunity doesn't come off, and it was a poor pass out from Neto and it gets out wide, and he's just looking to guide it in, but again there's only Bowen in there and he's really overhit then. It's gone out for a throw-in, but when you get in them areas, you've got to put a ball that someone's able to get on the end of, where if Bowen's there, it's got to be low or it's got to be picked out. If Souček is in there, then you've got the option to just sort of try and hang it up for him to go on to win it, because he's so good in the air. But it's disappointing when you get into them positions to just give an easy cross and it's going out the far side.
Foul on Jared Bowen, 10-12 yards outside the penalty area that West Ham attack. Free kick, James Ward-Prowse is not a shooting position, but he'll be hoping to tempt something in of a dangerous variety here. This is left of centre. West Ham playing right to left as we look down. Ward-Prowse standing over it. His teammates along the edge of the penalty area. It's floated in towards the box. There's a flick on header, but it's a way off target. It was a chance. And I think it was Socek who got the main touch on that. Goal kick to Bournemouth.
Yeah, that's more like it. What we were saying about Ward-Prowse and his set plays. Really good delivery in it. Everyone's just going back onto the 6-yard box. And there's a lot of people trying to go and win. And it's Souček. And he actually gets too much on it. He's tried to just guide it and flick it in over his right shoulder. But he actually gets too much on it and puts it wide. But again, good delivery. And that's where West Ham can get back into this game via a set play at the moment. Because at the moment, we're open play, it doesn't look like they're creating too much.
Phillips hustles well for it near the halfway line and plays the ball back to Areola. West Ham building from deep again. Mavropanos got the best pass out towards Johnson because Tavernier was on him, and Bournemouth are going to get it back again. Too many unforced errors tonight from West Ham. This is Ryan Christie for Bournemouth. Breaks into the penalty area, plays it back out to Tavernier again on the left-hand side. Kelly is up to support from left-back. Bournemouth, who've had a nice swagger about them tonight. Cook, challenge in the penalty area, goes down. He wants a spot kick. He was chasing after a ball. Mavropanos was the defender. Kelly immediately turned and roared at the referee. But Tim Robinson, who's in charge tonight, waves play on.
Yeah, Mavropanos just uses his body and just nudges him out the way. But, difficult that. He's right in just inside the box, and he's given the referee an opportunity to make a decision, which you don't necessarily want to do that at this moment in time.
Bournemouth fans are housed tonight down that end that their team are attacking in this second half. They were all roaring for the penalty kick too. VAR, of course, will look at all of this in the background. Simon Hooper is assisted by Eddie Smart this evening, but no penalty for Bournemouth there. 10 minutes played in the second half. Solanke's goal separating the teams. Dominic Solanke, what a run he's on. 9 goals in his last 10 Premier League games. And it's been a very quiet January transfer window, but you can be sure some teams would have been interested in taking Dominic Solanke, and Bournemouth will see it as a real coup that they've been able to hold on to him.
Yeah, he's been outstanding. And, you know, what team in the top half of the table or in the whole Premier League that wants a striker that's in form and scoring goals. So I'm sure there would have been many suitors, but for Bournemouth it's a fantastic window that they can keep hold of him.
This is Edson Alvarez through Calvin Phillips back to Emerson, back to Kurt Zouma. West Ham playing it around but still inside their own half. Phillips on his West Ham debut, having just joined from Manchester City in recent days, has not been a regular under Pep Guardiola, so every right to be a bit rusty, Calvin Phillips, and West Ham fans will hope they'll see the best of him in the coming weeks. Here's a chance. Alvarez, snapshot from the edge of the area. It hit the body of a defender. That took the sting out of it, and it was comfortably picked up by Neto.
Yeah, once again, it's out on the right-hand side with Johnson, who puts the cross in. It's not quite... it's not a great cross into the box, which gets cleared by Bournemouth defenders, but Alvarez, he does have a good strike from the edge of the box, but it never looked like it was going to trouble the goalkeeper, and the deflection just trickled it back to Neto.
Alvarez, who's never scored in the Premier League, got his first West Ham goal in the Europa League back in December. That was against Freiburg. Got four goals for Ajax in his last full season in the Netherlands, Edson Alvarez. Certainly got power in that shot, but couldn't get it through the defenders in the way. West Ham have it on the edge of their own penalty area. It is the Mexican on the ball. Rolls it to his left-hand side to Kurt Zouma. I believe this is the last night of the yellow ball, the high-vis ball of the Premier League. We go back to white balls from the weekend. So you always know spring has sprung when we get the new ball in the Premier League. This is Calvin Phillips out to the right-hand side to Ben Johnson. West Ham fans are doing their best to rouse a bit of an atmosphere here. Kudos, good acceleration, into the penalty area, down he goes. West Ham wants a penalty, but the referee doesn't flinch. Tim Robinson waves play on. VAR will look in the background. It was a good burst into the box by Kudos, but was he fouled?
Great wide play by Kudos. He does exactly what he did in the first half. He gave a little shimmy to fake to, he was coming in on his left-hand thigh and burst down the line, and he got his body in front of Kelly, and there is an arm on his shoulder, and he clips his leg, but I'm just trying to look at it now. Is the right arm comes across and his foot does take his back leg, Kudos. I mean, there's definite shout for a penalty there for me.
The ball has gone out of play. The referee has been asked to hold the restart here while the video assistant referee decides if this might be a penalty. Kelly seemed to lose his balance and was on the way down and fell into Kudos. Big roar from the supporters as they see the VAR are looking at this. I mean, it is clumsy, it is tangled. Is it going to be given as a penalty?
It's the right arm on Kudos' shoulder, but then it's the follow-through on the leg. It catches Kudos' left foot and it clips his leg, and that's why he goes down from the contact. It's just whether they necessarily think that is worth a penalty.
Yes, they're now looking at the build-up, the VAR, to suggest they're just looking to see if there was any other reason. This is going to be an opportunity for referee Tim Robinson to come to the sidelines to have a look at it himself, and that would indicate that the video assistant referee feels that it should be a penalty. Robinson makes his way across, and West Ham fans waiting to find out if they are going to get this spot kick. Referee, who had been walking over, breaks into a jog, and that's where they all roared. They wanted him to get over there quicker.
But I want to go back to Kudos' play. It was really good wide play. He's faked to go on his left-hand side, which he's done the last couple of times, and he's just shimmied down to the right and burst the pace, got himself across, and that's what's brought the foul. And for me, it looks like there's enough contact there to be given a penalty.
Tim Robinson looking at the replays on the pitch side monitor. We've described the situation. Kudos breaking into the penalty on the right. Kelly was behind him, leans forward, his right arm across the shoulder of Kudos. It's not an enormous foul, but then a tangle of legs too. And the referee's got to decide if that is a foul by the defender. And he's taking his time over. Look, this isn't just cut and dry, but here comes the decision. Penalty! The biggest roar of the evening from the West Ham United supporters. Kudos winning a penalty for West Ham and a chance for David Moyes' team to get this back to 1-1.
Great opportunity for West Ham here. We mentioned in the first half of Bournemouth should have been 2, maybe 3-0 up. but West Ham stayed in the game, and we said about set pieces or something, and it's Kudus this time that's been lively for one of the bright sparks for West Ham in the first half. He's the one that's changed this game, and it's Ward-Prowse that's going to step up to take this penalty.
James Ward-Prowse, who scored a penalty in West Ham's last game, the match against Sheffield United. He hoped would have been a winner at the time. Sheffield United came back with a penalty of their own to get the draw. But this is to drag West Ham from behind on a night that David Moyes' team have been misfiring. There is no margin for error here. Ward-Prowse has got to score this. Up against Neto. It's a right-footed kick from James Ward-Prowse, and he scores straight down the middle. West Ham have been far from their best tonight, but they've dug in there, they've held on, and James Ward-Prowse from the penalty spot has dragged his team back to 1-1.
Great penalty, so cool and calm, slotted it in, is just on that right hand side, keeper went the opposite way, really good penalty. But that's what West Ham have done this season. They've not necessarily played their best football, but they've got results, and tonight, really good. Really good for them to get back in this second half. They have done better the second half. First half, really poor. But they've started the second half well. They've managed to get Ward-Prowse in that higher central position, and Kudus the ball again. And it's the pair of them that have got West Ham back involved in this game.
It's the 53rd Premier League goal of James Ward-Prowse's career. Scored against Bournemouth twice in his Southampton days. That is priceless, absolutely priceless for West Ham. Now, can they turn the tide here, or can Bournemouth get a second wind of their own? It's not that Bournemouth were playing badly in the build-up to the goal. Times tonight, and Dori Iriola's team have been the dominant force. Can they get back to that status now? Here comes Tavernier over the halfway line, infield to Ryan Christie. Bournemouth playing from left to right as we look down. Good lively atmosphere now with both teams on the scoreboard. Semenyo back to Kelly, low ball into the penalty area. Areola's done really well. Mavropanos puts it out for a corner. That's a really good response to Bournemouth from conceding the goal down the other end. They nearly take the lead again.
Oh, we've got a game here. Brilliant play from Bournemouth. From the right out to the left, Semedo on the overlap was Kelly, and he's cross shot. Areola makes a good save, and it's out for a corner. Really entertaining.
Alex Scott to take. This is left hand side as Bournemouth come forward. Huge crowd of players inside the 6-yard box. It's high and it's swirling, and it's met by the firm forward of Kurt Zouma, who gets good distance away. Tavernier picks it up for Bournemouth. Alvarez breathing down his neck, so Bournemouth are forced to retreat back into their own half again, and the tide would appear to be turning here as West Ham force Bournemouth back. There's a new belief, a new confidence for a West Ham team that were off colour, out of sorts in the first half of this game. Suchek stretches, can't keep the ball in play on the far side, throw it to Bournemouth. Kelly takes it immediately up towards Scott. He'll play it out to the right wing, where there's a bit of room for Tavernier. Tavernier and Semenyo have swapped wings in this second half. Tavernier now operating on the right-hand side, where he's got Adam Scott for company up from right back. This is Cook near the halfway line, spinning away from James Ward-Prowse and playing a pass back to Senesi. Now out to Kelly on the left. Bournemouth looking to regain their rhythm and tempo now against the renewed interest of West Ham. Solanke's ball back to Semenyo. Too congested on the edge of the West Ham penalty area. Good slide by Ryan Christie to win possession back for his team again, just as West Ham thought they were going to get it away. There is a resolve, there's a toughness to Bournemouth that you can see. Mental toughness as much as anything else. A team that started this season terribly but have really had wind in their sails over the last few months. Now Solanke turns on the edge of the area, into the penalty area goes. Alvarez had to be very careful making the tackle, but he got the ball inside the penalty area. Now Calvin Phillips into Alvarez again. West Ham need to get rid here, and the Mexican does clear up to the halfway line. Matt Jarvis.
Yeah, well, again, straight from the goal, it's all Bournemouth again, and the way they're playing, the Semenya's now switched again. Tavernier's gone back out onto that left-hand side, and everything's really slick.
Christie here turns on the edge of the area, shot just wide. Bournemouth's best chance of the second half. graceful turn where he pirouetted 180 degrees, Roy Christie, to get into position to shoot. And from just outside the penalty area, he didn't blast it. It was a bit like Kevin De Bruyne's goal recently against Newcastle. He tried to pass it into the bottom corner, and he very nearly succeeded.
Yeah, really good from the left-hand side. Whipped into him. He's had a great touch and turn all in one motion. And then it's that left-hand whip into the bottom corner. It's just gone past the post. But again, since the goal, it's all Bournemouth again. And you thought the crowd had turned, West Ham fans were cheering. You thought, here we go. But it's all Bournemouth again.
So 1-1 here on Five Live Sports Extra. Manchester United are two goals in front in the first half at Molineux. Marcus Rashford, of course, scoring after all the headlines that he's made over the last week. And Rasmus Højlund has got another Premier League goal. And Manchester United leading by 2-0 away at Molineux. This evening, Manchester United, who are, if things were to stay like that, going to move up to one place behind West Ham in the table tonight. This is Soucek playing it out to Kudus. Now, chance. First time he's had a bit of space. Kelly's out of position for once. Kudus is tripped to the ground by Christie. Free kick to West Ham and a yellow card for Ryan Christie. And Kudus just too hot to handle there.
Yeah, that's why the crowd, every time Kudus gets the ball, you can hear the excitement, because he sucks people in, and as soon as they come to challenge him, the burst of speed and the shimmy in his body, and he just pushes it forward and gets caught. And again, it's a really good angle here on the right-hand side for Ward-Prowse to put the delivery in like he did once before.
So a yellow card for Ryan Christie. And just a bit of housekeeping notes that Kevin Nolan was shown a yellow card round about the time that West Ham scored the goal, so presumably that was some descent towards the fourth official. And there's activity down in the technical area. Bournemouth preparing two substitutes, two attacking players, Clive Ayrton, Sinisterra. They'll wait until after defending this free kick, though. James Ward-Prowse to take. Wide on the right-hand side. Plays it into the busy penalty area. Bowen on the back post gets a header, but puts it wide of the post. Goal kick to Bournemouth.
Yeah, Bowen, you've got to give him credit. He's actually very good in the air, and he scored quite a few goals. But that one is just a bit too far. He was out left-hand side of the box, and he just couldn't quite get the power or direction in that one.
Okay, both teams are going to make changes here. West Ham are going to bring on Danny Ings. But first of all, Sinisterra is out onto the grass. He'll replace Alex Scott for Bournemouth. Justin Kluivert coming on as well, and he's going to replace Semenyo. So Scott and Semenyo make way, Sinisterra and Kluivert come on. And with 67 minutes on the clock, midway through the second half, that is the end of Calvin Phillips' West Ham debut. It started horrifically for him. His back pass playing on Solanke to get the opening goal settled down a little bit as the game continued, but suffice to say West Ham will feel this is just getting back up to speed, and they will hope to see more and better from Calvin Phillips in the weeks to come on his loan move through to the end of the season. But Ings on for Phillips, and it's a striker on for a midfielder, and maybe a more formulaic regulation approach now from West Ham, with Ings taking the central striking role and Bowen being able to play on the left, Kudus on the right.
Yeah, and Ings will feel disappointed that he wasn't playing, because he had his best game really for West Ham in the last one against Crystal City. So really he'll be wanting to show everyone what he's about.
Played well, Danny Ings, against Sheffield United too at Bramall Lane. And the 2-2 draw. This is Solanke on the edge of the West Ham penalty area for Bournemouth. Tavernier is denied space, so he can't pick a pass. West Ham get it back again. This is Bowen. Bowen's done really well to skip away from two defenders, and Zabani slides in, and Zabani's hurt himself in that. He caught Bowen. Both players are down injured. Now this may take a little bit of time now as the medical staff decide if they're going to be needed. It's going to be a yellow card for Bowen. It was a great surge from him, but he had lost control of it, and he lunged in at the end and caught Zabani, who's getting back to his feet and won't need the physio.
Yeah, I just saw the replay. He's caught him on his foot. He was stretching and trying to get the ball, but he did catch him right on his foot.
Danny Ings, who's come on for Bournemouth, come on for West Ham, started his career at tonight's opponents, Bournemouth. Came through their youth system. They made a bit of money when they sold him as a youngster to Burnley. Here he is,
back on against his old club tonight. 1-1 at London Stadium with 20 minutes plus the stoppages to go. A point apiece as it stands.
Bournemouth like to, every like 60, 65 minutes, they like to change their wide players and freshen it up because they do a lot of work. The manager wants them to be chasing forward and high pressing, but he also needs them to do their defensive work. So by 60, 65 minutes, they tend to change them over and get fresh legs on to do it again. And Cliver and Sinisterra, they've been really effective for Bournemouth this season. So, again, for West Ham, they're going to have to make sure that they're on defensive duties, especially in them wide areas.
Bournemouth of possession, 1-1. Bournemouth, who took the lead very early in the game. West Ham back on level terms thanks to James Ward-Prowse's penalty in this second half. Bowen hard working, denies any room to Adam Smith, and the ball goes out of play for a throw-in to Bournemouth. Right full-back position for them. Iriola out bellowing the instructions on the edge of the technical area. David Moyes is out there too. Both coaches trying to get as close to the action as they can. Zuma got up early, but maybe too early. He was on his way back down again as the ball came to him. Alvarez regains possession for West Ham. Gives it to Ward-Prowse on the left-hand side. Nice footwork to skip away for the first tackle. Then he plays a 1-2 with Bowen. This is better now from West Ham. But then as I say that, the ball is given away by Danny Ings. Chance of a counter-attack for Bournemouth. Tavernier comes down the right wing. Christie to the byline right-hand side. Steps into the penalty area. It's really good from Christie. Low cross came off the right leg of the goalkeeper. And Areola's been able to get it away. He's been sharp tonight, Areola. He has needed to be.
He has. There's another really good driving run down this right-hand side. But the ball across, and Areola just sticks out a leg and gets a good touch on it. But he's had to be on his top game tonight. He's made some really good saves and he's kept West Ham right in it.
West Ham 1, Bournemouth 1. It's a game that feels there's more goals in it. As Kudos flicks the ball rather casually to Johnson, but gets away with that. West Ham do lose possession though inside their own half as Bournemouth get it back again, and one or two groans from the West Ham. Oh, that's a terrible ball by Smith. He's given it to Bowen. Now, can West Ham make the most of this? Bowen sprinting into Bournemouth territory. Good recovery by Adam Smith, who was the player who'd given... Oh, is it Smith, actually? Yes, it was. He was the player who'd given the ball away, and he fought hard to get back to slide and to put it out for the throw. West Ham throw on the left-hand side.
Yeah, when you give the ball away, you want to win it back as quickly as possible, and he's done that. He's defended really well. Cook just wins the ball back and gets his team a free kick. But Bournemouth have done that well tonight. They have. Every time there's been a break or a counter for West Ham, they've got back and defended well and got back in numbers. And you know, Bowen and Kudos have been isolated and doubled up on West Ham. They want them to have license to go and get in behind or have space to take players on. But Bournemouth have defended them really well.
Long clearance by Neto for Bournemouth. Zuma timed his jump better that time. Sochek flicks it on. Zabani back, bit of head tennis at London Stadium. Zuma gets it down onto the deck and then launches it with his left boot all the way up over the top and ultimately through to the Bournemouth goalkeeper. Neto away to our left-hand side. 1-1. BBC Radio 5 Sports Extra from Premier League coverage this evening. If you prefer to listen to events at Molineux, Manchester United leading away at Wolves, that is available right now over on our sister station 5 Live. This is Emerson passing in from the left full-back position, still inside his own half. Sochek back to Kurt Zouma. Get the energy being displayed by those attacking substitutes that Bournemouth have made. Cliver there running forward, putting pressure on Zouma, forcing him to clear it away, and Bournemouth get it back in the midfield. Tavernier's ball, looking for Solanke, nearly got through as well. Mavropanos with an important interception. Now, this is James Ward-Prowse to Ben Johnson. West Ham over the halfway line. Johnson's managed to pick out Bowen. He's into the penalty area. Tried to cut it back. And Smith, on the edge of his six-yard box, has been able to repel it away slightly. Not fully cleared. Sochek for West Ham. Tries to get it onto his right boot. Fell as he tried to hit it. There's appeals for a handball, but the referee waves play on. That was a chance. Bowen was unselfish. Tried to cut it back. And Bournemouth had enough bodies back there.
Yeah, really, really good chance. Bowen, at that point, he's on that right-hand side. Does he cut inside and try and take a shot on his left hand, his left foot? But no, he cuts it back to. He's trying to get it to Ward-Prowse, but it did get cut out. Bit of a ricochet. And in the end, it was Sochek that picks it up and does a great shimmy onto his right-hand side to get the shot away, but it's blocked. But it's an opportunity there for West Ham to at least get a shot on goal and hit the target, but again Bournemouth defended it well in the end.
Bournemouth had a fine month in December. They won four Premier League games straight. There's just a hold up here while one of the visitors receives treatment. We've seen the replay, the shot that came in might have come up Senesi's hand. That was the big roar from the West Ham fans. But while treatment has been given here, both sets of players coming over to the touchline, getting some liquids on board and getting some words of advice from the respective coaches. David Moyes has a long word with kudos and then comes over to talk to James Ward-Prowse as well. And big 15 minutes here, Matt, because this genuinely could go either way.
Yeah, I think Bournemouth would be thinking then that first time they should have at least got two or three goals. You know, they were dominating possession, dominating the chances, and it's only really that last 5 minutes the West Ham were able to get some sort of attack in it. But they started the second half really well, obviously got the penalty, and it's a completely different game now. It seems to be end to end, but both teams making positive changes with substitutions, and now, as you say, it could go either way.
On this week's Women's Football Weekly podcast, Ben Haynes and Ellen White are joined by Manchester City and England defender Esme Morgan. Monday's Football Daily podcast, we'll see Ben Haynes, Neda Manua, Adam Crafton and Stuart Downing reflect on the weekend's results. And a reminder that the Six Nations starts this weekend, and you can keep across that on Five Live and Sports Extra. Another Bournemouth player down, another hold up. In fact, there's two Bournemouth players down at the same time. One of them is Clivert, who's just come on. Kelly too. West Ham fans are making their dissatisfaction heard. They feel this is time wasting from Bournemouth. As on comes the physio, and another hold up.
Yeah, well, to be fair, Kelly's defended so well, but he's had kudos all game. So he's been a lot of energy to go up and back, and he's just down there. I don't know quite what it is at the moment, but they're getting someone warmed up just in case. But he's defended so well with Kudos, and his one chance that Kudos has got past him is the penalty. So he's unfortunate in that he's done so well, but that one opportunity Kudos has made him pay.
So looks like Bournemouth are going to make a change here. Kelly is slowly walking across the field, making his way towards the technical area, and they do have a ready made replacement, good to go at left back. Milos Kerkez, who's played in that position for much of this campaign, returned against Swansea in the FA Cup last weekend. Before that he had missed five games in all competitions, but Kerkez fit again, and that is a ready made replacement to come in and play at left back. It takes the place of Kelly.
I hope for him he's had a good warm up, because as soon as Kudos is going to get the ball, he's going to run at him.
Kukansu to place an attacking threat of his own. He's sent more crosses into the penalty area than any other Bournemouth player this season in the Premier League. Play will get back underway with a free kick to the visitors. Tavernier plays it into the penalty area, and a header won by Ben Johnson at the far post. Flag raised anyway. Bournemouth were offside as the free kick came in, and West Ham aren't happy with that, because Johnson cleared it away down the field. Bowen was sprinting after it. West Ham wondering if they might have had an advantage there, but the referee had already blown the whistle.
Yeah, I think the West Ham fans are just trying to get their team going. I don't think they're too disappointed with that, but it's an improvement, much improved second half by David Moyes tactically, and his team have started to get in the right positions and put a lot of pressure on Bournemouth, his back four, which, you know, that's the key for them. They weren't able to get sustained pressure and get their wide players in high up the pitch and be able to put a lot of pressure into this back line, which they have in this second half.
Here comes Clivert for Bournemouth. Good surge down the right-hand side. He's pulled it into the penalty area, and Tavernier got it stuck between his legs. He just needed to dig it out and he would have had a shot at goal. Good build-up from Bournemouth, a reminder that they are still an attacking threat, but no doubt that West Ham have improved in the game. Here they come again. Ward-Prowse out to Bowen on the right wing, stepping into the penalty area, tried to shoot with his left foot, came off a defender, but it came back off the West Ham man. It's not going to be a corner, it's a goal kick 2, Bournemouth. West Ham 1, Bournemouth 1 here, just over 10 minutes to go.
That is end-to-end as well. Clivert showing what pace he's got up the other end, attacking Kurt Zouma, knocked it past him, put a really good ball into Tavernier, and he only had to get control of it, and he was inside the six-yard box with a free shot at goal. Just couldn't quite control it. And then straight from that is kudos out to Bowen, up to the other side, and Bowen just tried to cut inside on his left foot like he loves to do on that side, but the ball ricocheted back off the defender, hit him and went out for a goal kick.
Now the foul's been committed at the moment, this latest one on Socek. Is a free kick to West Ham. Ball, in fact, it was, who was fouled there in the far side of the pitch. This is BBC Radio 5 Sports Extra, London Stadium. Bournemouth scored early, West Ham have got it back to 1-1. And it's a game in the balance going into the final 10 minutes plus the stoppages here. Mavropanos takes the free kick over the top. Bowen sprinting after it. He's done really well to keep that in play at the byline. Had to juggle it right on the exterior of the pitch, but he's managed to get it back into the middle. Ward-Prowse with the layoff that was clever, looking for Danny Ings, but alert goalkeeping from Neto, who gets out to smother it. Good play from West Ham.
Yeah, good play straight away from Bowen, makes that run in behind, and he's back out on his favoured right-hand side here. We've got Ings down the middle, Bowen on the right, and Kudos on this left, and he controls it, brings people into play again, and he just looks more comfortable straight away. He's been involved more for West Ham on this right-hand side. So again, for David Moyes, a good shift of tactics. Ings coming on, Kudos on this left-hand side, Bowen on the right.
Bournemouth, who started this season without a win in any of their opening 9 Premier League games. If they win this evening, they would have 28 points from 21 matches. That would be the club's best ever tally to this stage of a Premier League campaign. It's been a remarkable recovery. Here they come, looking for that goal to get back in front. Solanke into the penalty area. Defenders around him, and it's cleared away by Socek. But there's still plenty energy in the Bournemouth attack whenever the ball comes up towards them. Here's Sinisterra on the far side. He's got fresh legs, having only been recently introduced. Turns on the edge of the penalty area. He's asked too much, has he, of Kerkez. Johnson, the defender, wasn't able to firmly get it away. Tavernier has kept it alive for Bournemouth. They are still on the attack here. Back to Senese, who's midway into West Ham territory. West Ham 1, Bournemouth 1. 8 minutes of normal time to play. Sinisterra steps into the penalty area. A dancing, chinking run. Still goes, cut back at himself a few times there, but ultimately couldn't get a pass or a shot away. And anywhere will do for Jared Bowen as he clears for West Ham. But it becomes a decent pass up to Danny Ings. And Ings is fouled by Cook, and that's a free kick to West Ham. And it might be a yellow card for Lewis Cook too.
Yeah, really entertaining now. Bournemouth playing so well. You can see why Solanke's got so many goals this season. He's so short. He's got such burst of pace, and he's unfortunate to not be able to get the shot off when he was in the box. But West Ham defending so well in that far side of the corner. Ben Johnson gets it, and Bowen just whips it up the line to just try and clear it. But that's the energy of Ings coming on fresh, sprinting over, gets a little flick in front of him, wins his team a free kick in the attacking third.
Is there going to be a winning goal in this game tonight? If it stays like this, West Ham will move to 36 points. They would be 7 behind Aston Villa in 5th. Manchester United leading at halftime at Molineux. If it stays like that, Manchester United would be a point behind West Ham in 7th. And in terms of Bournemouth's situation, a point as it stands would lift them ahead of Fulham and up into 12th place in the table this evening. That's all as things stand. 6.5 minutes of normal time to play. Zabani has possession for Bournemouth on the halfway line. Gives it to Senesi. Ambitious diagonal ball out towards Sinisterra. Puts Johnson under pressure at right back, and he stretches, and the ball goes out down by the corner flag, but out for a throw-in. Throw-in to Bournemouth to run the attack here. Feels that there's going to be one big chance, maybe one big chance at either end. And the question is, who will be able to take that opportunity if it comes?
Yeah, both teams fully attacking, both defending, both attacking forward. It's counter-attacking football.
It is. And the latest cross from the left-hand side. He's too close to the goalkeeper from Clivert, and well held on to by Areola. West Ham fans wanted him to distribute it quicker. Balls it out low to Kurt Zouma. West Ham make their way up towards the halfway line. Zouma lays it off to Emerson. Cuts in field, off the left. Fancies a little dribble deeper into Bournemouth territory, but he's pass, but it's laid off towards Danny Ings. Possession is given away. Christie has worked hard all night, does well for Porth, and now there's room for Tavernier on the right-hand side, and the end-to-end nature of this game continues. Tavernier attacking down the right for Bournemouth. Cuts back at himself and looks for support. Ryan Christie provides it. Nice swing of the hips to go around Danny Ings. Now, Sinisterra into the penalty area. Shoots right footed, comes off Mavropanos and bounces away for a corner. Another Bournemouth chance and a Bournemouth corner.
He's looked lively, Sinisterra, since he's come on. He's gone down the line a few times for Johnson, but this time he cuts inside his right foot, takes a great shot. Mavropanos stands up brave, hits him right on the top of the head, out for a goal kick, but Areola was a big dive over to that far side, and it was definitely going on target.
Sinisterra, who scored against Swansea in the FA Cup last week, that was the 5-0 game. His most recent Premier League goal came against Fulham on Boxing Day. He has been lively since his late introduction in this game tonight. 5 minutes to go, corner to be taken at the far side, an in-swinger, James Ward-Prowse heads it out. Kudos controls on the edge of the box for West Ham, and he's managed to release himself from the shackles of the first defender, and he's away at a canter down the right wing. Bournemouth working really hard to get bodies back. Senesi's got to be careful, wrapped his arm around Kudos. Referee waves his right hand in the air to indicate that it was a foul, but he's allowing play to continue because West Ham still have possession, and they've got it back to Kudos just on the edge of the penalty area. Sinisterra back there working really hard to regain possession, and Bournemouth get it back again. It's still 1-1.
It was a great break, but Kudos, I think he ran out of steam on that last one. Sinisterra doing really well to come back and help his team out, but he tried to cut inside again onto his left foot to try and get a shot away, but Sinisterra read it really well, and Bournemouth are back on the attack.
Yeah, Bournemouth's turn now. Ball is played by Smith down the right channel. Solanke really strong against Kurt Zouma, and that 50-50 shoulder charge. Solanke bundled big Kurt Zouma down onto the ground. Not many people will do that. Ball went out of play for a Bournemouth throw. They've taken it quickly, and then it's passed by Cook back to the halfway line to Zabani once again. Sinisi, left-footed ball, it's a great ball into the penalty area. Tavernier is after it, jumping under pressure from Mavropanos, and then Solanke can't control when it drops from a height. It came off his shin pad more than his boot, and that goes out for a goal kick to West Ham, for whom Edson Álvarez is just a little slow to get back up to his feet. He is standing again, but he obviously got a knock there.
Yeah, he's worked hard, Álvarez, tonight. He's had to, because in that middle of the pitch, they've been very lively, Bournemouth. So he's done a lot of work, a lot of defensive tracking back, lots of challenges, and he's looking like he's a bit war wounded.
3 minutes of normal time to play. Areola's clearance, right-footed, up over the halfway line, flicked on by Suchek initially, but he can't pick out a teammate. Solanke isn't able to judge the flight to the ball in the air. Back down on the deck now for Mavropanos, who rolls it to his right-hand side into Ben Johnson. If you're joining our coverage late, Solanke scored early. Mistake by Calvin Phillips, who was given a bit of a hospital pass on the edge of his own penalty area. But he played onside Solanke with the back pass and allowed Bournemouth score inside 4 minutes. And then a James Ward-Prowse penalty in the second half after Kudos was taken down by Kelly. That looked like a handball by Kudos as he went to control it in the penalty area. The referee says play on for now, but that's just a brief intervention because it is handball, and it is a free kick to Bournemouth, still 1-1.
Yeah, unfortunately, he's done well to drop high, but it's the flick from Smith that goes onto Kudos' hand, and it's a definite free kick. And Neto's making sure that everyone's up the pitch, going over to this right-hand side, because it's, what is it, 88th minute, and it could go either way. Both teams really trying to get that last opportunity to get the win here.
West Ham, who've had a lot of draws lately, if it stays like this, it'll be their third consecutive draw back-to-back in the Premier League. But it would also be five top-flight matches unbeaten for West Ham. Still no victory in any competition in 2024, though. The wins are proving hard to come by. West Ham have had to come from behind tonight. This is James Ward-Prowse. Gives it back to Emerson, who had taken a throw. Nice movement as Kudos now has taken up a position on the left wing. And he plays it right-footed into the penalty area. Needed more height. Christie was able to clear it away with his head. Johnson has picked it up for West Ham. He's midway inside Bournemouth territory. Nice little cut pass back to Jared Bowen, who's seeing a bit more of the ball now since Danny Ings has come in as the central striker, and Bowen can roam a bit more. This is Emerson, gets to within 10 yards of the penalty area that West Ham are attacking. Now Kudus on the left wing. That's a better cross this time, but Sinisi gets up well and heads it away for Bournemouth. Still 1-1 on Sports Extra. Mavropanos for West Ham, who you feel are going to throw everything at this late on to try and get a winner, but Mavropanos' pass was careless there. He's given it away to Christie, and Christie's ball down the left wing is too far in front of Sinisera, and that gives possession back to West Ham again, and we're about to move into stoppages, and Bournemouth are going to make a late change.
Yeah, it is really end-to-end. Both teams are going for the win, but every opportunity that the attacking team get, as soon as they lose it, it's a counter-attacking game. And at the moment, it's Kudus that's trying his best to get West Ham going again.
8 minutes to be added on for stoppages. Bournemouth about to bring on their number eight, Romain Favre. This will be his debut for Bournemouth. He has charged down through the middle of the pitch here by Sinisterra, plays a pass to Kluivert just inside the penalty area that Bournemouth attack on the right hand side. His low ball come in, hits the body of Kurt Zouma. Hands were down by his side anyway. Bournemouth fans claiming a penalty, but they're not going to get it. Throw into Bournemouth, who remain on the attack down the right hand side. 8 minutes of stoppages, Matt. Plenty time for either of these teams to get a winner.
Plenty of time. Honestly, it's going to be one opportunity for either side, really, and it's just whether they can make it pay. There's always going to be that one chance, and Kluivert and Sinisterra both look lively since they've come on, but it's Ings that's made a difference here, because it's meant the shape has changed, and Bowen's gone onto the right and Kudus onto the left, Ward-Prowse down the middle, and they've looked a lot more comfortable, West Ham.
Romain Favre, who's been a recent £13 million signing. The Frenchman comes on, having played with Lyon and Monaco in the past. He was on loan at Lorient in the first half of this campaign. He's on for his Bournemouth debut. West Ham win possession with the energetic Jared Bowen on the far side. He took it away from Sinisterra. He's still going, Bowen. It's a great run. He's made up 30 yards here. Deep into Bournemouth territory, then it all breaks down. Kirkes gets it back for Bournemouth. Bowen's slow to get back to his feet. He must be exhausted. But the game continues. We haven't played two of the 8 minutes yet. Bournemouth trying to come on the attack. Favre involved for the first time. Kluivert wasn't expecting the pass to come to him from short range. Took his eye off it. West Ham regained possession. Danny Ings inside his own half. Tight corner. Not much he could do there. He's just cleared it down the left channel. Cook will sprint back and roll it to the goalkeeper, Neto. Who wants this more? Who's got to get the big moment that could win the match? West Ham are preparing another late change of their own. Maxwell Cornet is getting ready for his introduction. It's not going to have long to make an impact. This is Christie on the halfway line for Bournemouth. Bournemouth playing left to right as we look down in the light blue. West Ham in their traditional claret and blue. Sinisi, midway inside his own half, surveys the options, rolls it short to his right-hand side to Zabanyi. Kluivert's made a good run ahead. Now this is intended for him. Kluivert trying to get in around the back of Kurt Zouma. Good acceleration from big Kurt Zouma, beating Kluivert to it and putting it out for a throw.
Yeah, he's done well there, because that's the area that Kluivert's been trying to run into since he's come on. It's this right-hand side. Kurt Zouma's playing the left ball, left centre-half here, and he keeps making that run, but Kurt Zouma's done really well there, getting his pace back in and getting it out for a throw-in.
Throw-in for Bournemouth on the attack down the right-hand side. Smith gives it short to Favre. He will try and turn, goes down under a challenge from Emerson. Bournemouth want a free kick, but I think that's just going to be a throw. Complaints towards the referee's assistant from Bournemouth players who went to the free. Is it going to be? No, it is. It is, as predicted, a throw-in to Bournemouth. Smith to take. West Ham have to bring bodies back to defend. This is around about 15 yards from the corner flag that Bournemouth attack on the right. The throw-in is back to Zabanyi. He passes back to the halfway line to Sinisi. Bournemouth reset. Now, ball trying to get in around the back of Ben Johnson, is cut out by the West Ham fullback. He's done well tonight in the absence of Vladimir Soufal. Socek gives it away in the midfield. Favre pushes it on to Ryan Christie. Still good, quick, rapid movement about Bournemouth when they're in possession. We've now reached the midway point of the 8 minutes that have been added on. That's a great ball. Sinisterra into the penalty area. Left-hand side for Bournemouth. Three defenders standing up ahead of him. So he's got to play it wide outside again. West Ham at the moment have everyone back trying to keep Bournemouth at bay. They want to win it themselves, of course, West Ham. But first and foremost, they don't want to concede a late goal here and lose the match at home. Christie has it. That's a nice ball. Favre, 10 yards outside the area on his debut. Rolls it to the right-hand side to Smith, who's put too much on it. From inside the penalty, it's blasted across. That sails over everyone. That's wasteful. And out it goes for a West Ham throw.
And it was great play from Favre. He's just put a really good ball into Smith. And he's just tried to hit it too hard. He's trying to put everything into it to try and get it into that area. And he's just overhit it. It's gone out for a throw-in. But it was a really good area. And you expect a little bit more. Last few minutes of the game, just slip it in low. If you're going low, there's three Bournemouth players all coming into the centre of the box. Just keep it low.
So a late throw of the dice from David Moyes. He's going to take off Mohamed Kudus, who's just back for the Africa Cup of Nations. And he will bring on Maxwell Cornet, who last time out against Sheffield United was his first Premier League appearance since August. And he scored in that game. He's only got a matter of minutes here to try and make an impact tonight. 2.5 minutes of the initially announced 8 minutes to go this evening. Ambitious ball out towards Sinisterra from Bournemouth on the far side is cut out. Johnson has it. West Ham pinned in it right back. He tries to clear but he can't. Gets a second attempt. Then it comes off Christie and that goes out for a throw into West Ham midway inside their own half. But Bournemouth are doing a very good job here of containing David Moyes' team deep in their own territory for almost all of the stoppages period we've had so far.
Yeah, you can hear the West Ham fans now. They want Ben Johnson to get on with it as well. He's trying to take this throw in, but there's not a lot on for him. And they want the West Ham players to get it forward. They want that opportunity to take this win.
Cornet involved for the first time, but he can't hold it up in a congested area near the centre circle. Favre's given it away. Cornet for West Ham. Gives it to Emerson on the left-hand side. A little bit too fancy there as he tried to come infield to Christie, but he ran into other trouble. And Bournemouth get the ball back, and West Ham fans are very frustrated there. Christie keeps it moving up to Kluivert, but Kluivert was in an offside position as he had the ball played to him there. And that's going to be a free kick to West Ham. And time is really running out now. Just over a minute of the eight to go. Free kick for West Ham, which Zuma is going to leave for Areola, who's come way out of his penalty area to take. He might as well launch this. Alphonse Areola, who's made some important saves in the game. If it weren't for him, West Ham might well have lost this as early as the first half. They could have been 3-0 down at the break. Long clearance, flicked on by Socek. Controlled by Jared Bowen, who's still a good 15, nearly 20 yards outside the penalty area that West Ham attack. He gives it to Emerson on the left-hand side. Is there to be a big blockbuster finish at London Stadium tonight? Cheers for the West Ham fans as Cornet retreats. They want the ball played forward, but Zuma's rushed that, and he's given it away to Sinisterra, and now maybe a chance for Bournemouth. West Ham have committed players down the other end. Sinisterra plays it to the edge of the West Ham penalty area. Kluivert tries to cross. An outstretched leg from Zuma made an interception, but West Ham haven't been able to fully clear it away. Ball from Christie into the penalty area, looking for Sinisterra, and Mavropanos puts it out for a throw on the far side.
Yeah, this is the unbelievable what happens here. You've got the West Ham crowd trying to G their team off. They're getting disappointed that Kone's played it back to Zuma. So Zuma feels the pressure and he has to try and get the ball forward, but he misplaces the pass, and then Bournemouth are attacking. And that's what it is in these last few moments. You have to keep your composure because Bournemouth had a really good opportunity to get that winner right at the end.
It's difficult to decide who would be the most satisfied with a draw here, because Bournemouth had the lead, might have lengthened it. West Ham at home after a run of two draws in their last game. I think they'll both be disappointed if this finishes 1-1. That's why they're going at it. Hammer and tongs laid on. Smith attacking with purpose down the right-hand side. Gives it back to Romain Favre, who has picked up a yellow card on his debut as the referee blows. The final whistle and boos ring around the London Stadium. So 1-1 it finishes. Solanke early in the game. James Ward-Prowse from the penalty spot just after the hour mark. It is 3 Premier League draws back-to-back for David Moyes. 5 Premier League matches unbeaten. West Ham remain very much in the hunt for European football next season.
but Solanke continues his goal-scoring run on what was a debut quite possibly to forget for Calvin Phillips. He will hope for better as he goes forward. And James Ward-Prowse proving again what a shrewd acquisition he's been. His goal from the penalty spot has saved the day for West Ham here. Matt Jarvis.
Yeah, well, I think Areola needs a lot of praise for his performance in the first half, keeping West Ham in the game, because that we mentioned it in the first half, how, you know, set pieces are going to be vital for West Ham on one opportunity, and they kept themselves in it, and Areola was vital with that. But Bournemouth, they should have been away in the first half, should have been 2 or 3 up. Their performance, the way that their chances that they created, and they should have made West Ham pay. But in the second half, it was just end to end. Both teams were trying to win it, which is great to watch, but it was just that final end product. Their final pass or the cross just wasn't quite good enough.
Well, 1-1 it finishes. A draw in August of the vitality between these two. They draw again here tonight at London Stadium. It's the first time that West Ham and Bournemouth have ever drawn two games against each other back-to-back. Forthcoming fixtures for the pair of them. Well, West Ham will travel to face David Moyes' old side Manchester United next. That is on Sunday. West Ham's next home game is the visit of Arsenal here the following Sunday. And after that, the Hammers go to Nottingham Forest. For Bournemouth, they've become very difficult to beat now. They host Nottingham Forest next. That's on Sunday. Then it's back-to-back away games at Fulham and Newcastle, and there is still much to be fought for in the remainder of this Premier League season. We still have virtually half the campaign to go. Bournemouth have every right to think that they can finish in the top half of the table the way they're going at the moment.
Yeah, they really do, and their performances show that. It has taken a while for this team to form and to have a style of play, but you can see it tonight, especially in that first half. It's the quickness, it's the press, it's the fluid of passing in between from left to right, but through the midfield into the strikers. And as we said, they've got pace and power in their front three, and they can change it. After 60, 65 minutes, they change it, and they've got more wide players that can come on and create, and they're a danger to the defending team. So they've got a real good opportunity to kick on at this end of this season and get themselves as high as possible.
And just a final word on West Ham, Matt. Yet to win a game in any competition in 2024. We're now into February. David Moyes will want to change that, but it's not going to be difficult. Sorry, not going to be easy with Manchester United and Arsenal the next two games.
Yeah, I think, you know, Paquetá's been vital for the way that they've been playing. He's been a massive miss being injured. I think he just makes them tick, and his assists and the way he brings Bowen and Kudos into the game. So I think he's been a huge miss, so they'll want to get him back as quickly as possible. But as you say, really difficult fixtures coming up.
Okay, well, thanks to Matt Jarvis for watching this game with us tonight at the London Stadium. Bournemouth scoring early, West Ham digging in and fighting back. It finishes West Ham United 1, Bournemouth 1.